Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Pak Hari, bagaimana kabarnya?
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ini Mbak Riza apa Mbak Laras yang bicara?
Riza, Bapak.
Mana wajahnya? Star. Dito.
Riza.
Halo. Oh iya, iya. Ini ada Pak Mustafa. Ini alumni Chengdu ya.
Dalam Pak.
Yang alumni Chengdu mana Chengdu?
Apa itu ya? Apa itu ya? Cina Lija.
Oh.
Alumni Chengdu. Sepertinya sebentar lagi Pak baru join.
Oh ya ya ya. Sao sang hao, Profesor Jailin. Ni hao.
Kamu tadi gini masih nyala kamera.
Ini ada Mbak Naris ya.
Bu Naris masih ini Pak, sebentar lagi gabung.
Di mana ini Mbak? Panggilannya Riza atau Rahmi?
Riza Bapak.
Riza. Saya pikir ya. Mas-mas.
Jadi Riza apa namanya? Nanti Bu Naris jadi MC Pak Hari.
Wah, mantap. Suruh pakai Mandarin.
Siapa?
Ini banyak yang mau ikut loh, Mbak.
Iya,
yang
Bapak.
Dari luar-luar.
Ini tapi akhirnya tadi kami mengaktifkan ke seluruhnya Pak, jadi boleh dari Poliwangi, boleh seluruhnya. Ini ternyata ada
dari
juga
mana-mana yang juga boleh itu.
Dari UNES, jadi sudah banyak yang gabung juga Pak.
Iya, banyak yang ingin mendengar update.
Selamat datang Pak Hari.
Wah, Mbak Naris, waduh. Apa
nanti
kabar
Mbak Naris? Sudah. Nggih, pandeminya sudah berakhir, main lagi ke Banyuwangi nggih, Pak?
Oh, siap. Ini malah Pak Son ada di Jakarta.
Iya. Yang bertugas di Jakarta bersama Wadir-Wadir.
Iya. Katanya nanti pulang dari Jakarta dia harus di apa? Harus di 14 hari itu.
Oh iya. Karantina.
Karantina mandiri. Tapi kalau Banyuwangi mah tidak banyak klaster ya. Jadi
ya, ya, tapi meningkat terus ini Pak kondisinya. Jumlahnya itu meningkat.
Ya, karena kan apa ya? Itu kan penularannya melalui omongan, melalui ludah, melalui. Jadi jangan deket-deket gitu sama orang. Ya, sama pohon aja. Jadi yang oh ini Pak Son, good morning. Ni hao.
Ni hao, Pak Hari. Alhamdulillah.
Profesor Chang. Xiao Sang Hao.
Hello.
Hey, good morning.
You look so You look so fresh, yeah. So young.
Yeah. Long time no see.
Yeah. Well, the coronavirus is slowing down the world, the yeah. globe.
How about Jakarta?
I think we have. Oh, Jakarta is it's not good lah. Almost every day we have a positive COVID around 2,000. Every day.
Yeah. So in Taiwan it's same.
Good, because I know your experience from the yeah. last SARS, yeah? yeah. And you are the only country that already prepared.
So maybe the day after tomorrow, have two Indonesia students will come back to my school.
Yeah, but they will be quarantined 14 days, okay? Yes? Yeah.
Okay, yes.
Yes. So how about if they are positively infected? What is the process in your university?
It's okay.
Professor Chang.
Yeah.
No. My question is, if the two Indonesian students that's coming tomorrow, they are infected by the coronavirus, what is the procedures?
No. And we will prepare for the dormitory for the student. And the student will stay in the special dormitory just for 2 weeks. After 3 weeks, okay. We will test anything is okay. We will have a regular living, like the study and the living with the student. But now the special dormitory just for one person. One special room is just for.
But if not okay,
okay.
What's it? If they are not okay.
Okay. That's okay. The school and our government will support the NDCs. We will give them very good the medicine. Yeah, no problem. And the NDC is free.
So they will. Yeah. Good. That is a very good news. If they are becoming sick of COVID, yeah. Then they will go to hospital.
Yeah, and we'll go to the hospital.
Yes.
And, in the hospital, we will give the special take care for that student. But I think it's important is the fear of the medicine fear. And this, the government will support. So don't worry about this.
Okay. Okay, thank you. That is the problem.
Yeah.
We are thinking.
Okay. Okay.
Professor Jay.
Din, Professor Din. Din Jim ya.
Professor Jaylin.
Morning.
Good morning. Welcome over.
Professor Jaylin.
Yes. The professor.
Morning. Good morning.
Okay. Hi. Oh, this.
All of the old friends. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Sushi.
Yeah. Okay. Tadahari, I have another meeting. I must go to another meeting. So this the meeting just give the professor Lin and the professor.
Oh, kan, semalam.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you, Sushi.
Okay. Bye bye.
Bye-bye, Jesse, Jajian.
Okay. Okay.
Teguh.
Ya, Pak.
Teguh. Kalau udah siap di sana kita nanti lapor ke ini di sini host-nya kita siap saja. Sudah. Kalau sana sudah siap ya.
Pertama saya mau dimulai mungkin cepet.
Cek dulu pesan bentong.
Masih tunggu 5 menit apa ya? Kasih 5 menit lagi Pak.
Oke. Okay. Iya ya, oke. Okay. Jadi nanti yang akan muncul siapa aja Teguh?
Yang akan bicara ntar Profesor J, Profesor Li, dan Profesor Chang, tiga orang.
Oh iya. Tadi Pak siapa?
Ini Profesor Chang itu apa wakil rektor sini Pak?
Enggak, yang rapat itu saya lupa namanya.
Profesor Chang.
Chen ya, Profesor Chen ya.
Chen.
Pak.
我們在上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面上面 可以，那。是，老师需要剪刀笔。剪刀笔，它不是调画面的，对啊，调画面的。哦。 我们这边看歪的没关系的，反正他屏幕那边收视率是正的，这样就好。就这样说 ，OK 了。哎，他们主持人不用讲了，就直接我们讲，哈利也不用讲。
哈利，我先把哈利。
Teguh, semua udah siap, Teguh?
Ya, sudah siap, Pak. We can start. Okay.
Kita mulai saja, Pak Son. Kami persilahkan, saya tamat
siap,
dulu.
Siap.
Siap. Saya ikuti aja prosedur dari sana. Terima ya. Kasih.
Silakan, Bu Risa.
Baik, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera bagi kita semua. Salam, Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, salam kebajikan. Greetings to all of us. Thank you for attendance in this webinar sharing session program 2+ICAI Taiwan. Yang terhormat Direktur Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi Bapak Son Kuswadi, Dr. Engineering. Yang kami hormati Senior Advisor to the Minister of Infrastructure Bapak Hari Purwanto, Dr. Engineering. Insinyur Magister of Science Diploma of Imperial College. The Honorable Assistant Professor and Director of Foreign Affairs Section, Cheongsu University Taiwan, Mr. Jay Lin. The Honorable Assistant Professor, Cheongsu University Taiwan, Mr. Howard Chang. The Honorable Associate Professor, Cheongsu University Taiwan, Mr. Low Li. Yang kami hormati International Affairs, Cheongsu University Taiwan, Bapak So Teguh Siddhartha. Yang kami hormati Koordinator Unit Kerjasama dan Urusan Internasional Ibu Riza Rahimi Bahtiar, SP, MP, MBA. Alumni Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, Awardees of 2+I Industry Academia Collaboration Program Indonesia-Taiwan, dan seluruh hadirin webinar yang berbahagia. Sebelum acara webinar kita mulai, berikut saya bacakan petunjuk teknis webinar yang diantaranya. Oke, yang pertama, peserta diharuskan menuliskan nama dan instansi yang sesuai saat melakukan registrasi untuk memudahkan narasumber dan moderator mengidentifikasi yang bertanya atau menanggapi. Yang kedua, peserta wajib mengkondisikan speaker dalam kondisi diam atau mute saat acara berlangsung. Bagi peserta yang hendak mengajukan pertanyaan dalam sesi diskusi, silakan mengajukan pertanyaan melalui fitur chat room pada Zoom dan YouTube. Peserta diwajibkan untuk mengisi link presensi saat kegiatan berlangsung dan memberikan feedback kegiatan webinar yang dilakukan sebagai prasyarat menerima e-sertifikat. Yang kelima, materi dan link rekaman video webinar akan disampaikan setelah webinar selesai. Yang keenam, e-sertifikat peserta webinar akan disampaikan selambat-lambatnya 3 hari setelah kegiatan webinar selesai. Baik, pertama-tama tidak kata yang paling indah yang patut kita ucapkan selain ucapan syukur kita kehadirat Tuhan Yang Maha Esa. Karena berkah dan juga hidayahnya kita semua bisa berkumpul dan mengikuti kegiatan webinar sharing session ini pada hari ini dalam keadaan sehat walafiat. Baik, berikutnya saya akan bacakan susunan acara pada kegiatan webinar sharing session program 2+ICAI Taiwan sebagai berikut. Acara yang pertama yaitu pembukaan webinar sharing session bersama alumni Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, Awardees 2+I Industry Academia Collaboration Program Indonesia-Taiwan. The first agenda is opening webinar sharing session with Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi alumni. Menyanyikan lagu Indonesia Raya diikuti semua peserta, singing National Anthem Indonesia Raya, sambutan oleh Ketua Panitia, opening speech head of committee, pembukaan dan sambutan oleh Direktur Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, opening speech by the Director of Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, pembukaan dan sambutan oleh Cheongsu University, opening speech by Cheongsu University Taiwan, pemaparan narasumber oleh Bapak Hari Purwanto, narrative exposure by Mr. Hari Purwanto, pemaparan narasumber oleh Profesor Jay Lin, narrative exposure by Profesor Jay Lin, pemaparan narasumber oleh Profesor Howard Chang, narrative exposure by Profesor Howard Chang, pemaparan narasumber oleh Mr. Liu Li, narrative exposure by Mr. Liu Li, sharing session, tanya jawab, discussion, penutup, closing, and photo session. Baik, memasuki acara yang pertama, yaitu pembukaan. Mari kita buka acara webinar kali ini dengan berdoa menurut kepercayaan masing-masing. Before we start it, let us pray in accordance with trust respectively. Let's pray start. Finis. Thank you. Selanjutnya, mendengarkan lagu kebangsaan Indonesia Raya. Acara selanjutnya yaitu sambutan oleh Ketua Panitia kepada Ibu Riza Rahini Bahtiar, SPMP MBA, disilahkan.
Baik, terima kasih Bu Nari selaku MC. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat pagi, salam sejahtera untuk kita semua. Pertama-tama saya mengucapkan terima kasih banyak atas kehadirannya. Dan di dalam opening speech ini saya akan menggunakan dua bahasa, yaitu bahasa Indonesia dan bahasa Inggris. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Riza Rahimi Bahtiar. In here, I'm as Head of Collaboration and International Affairs, and also Head of Committee. And in this opening speech, I will use two language, that is Bahasa Indonesia and English. First of all, I would like to say thank you so much to the Honorable Mr. Son Kuswadi, Dr. Engineering, as the Director of Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, Mr. Hari Purwanto, Dr. Engineering, Insinyur, MSc, DIC, as Senior Advisor to the Ministry for Infrastructure, Professor Jay Lin as Assistant Professor and Director of Foreign Affairs Section, Jiangsu University, Taiwan, to Professor Howard Chang as Assistant Professor, Jiangsu University, Taiwan, Mr. Lo Li, Associate Professor, Jiangsu University, Taiwan, to Mr. So Teguh Siddhartha as International Affairs, Jiangsu University, Taiwan, Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi Alumni, awardees of 2+I Industry Academy Collaboration Program Indonesia-Taiwan, to Mr. Dedi Hidayat Kusuma ST, MCS, as Vice Director of Academic at Politeknik Banyuwangi, Mr. Fuad Alharis ST, MT, as the Vice Director of Public Affairs and Finance at Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, Mr. Muhammad Sofiul Amin, STMT, as Vice Director of Student Affairs at Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, and all of participants and committee. 2+I CAI Program Indonesia-Taiwan adalah program kerjasama pendidikan antara Indonesia dan Taiwan, dan program ini adalah salah satu program bagi mahasiswa Indonesia khususnya untuk melakukan studi di Taiwan. Mahasiswa dapat melanjutkan studi di Taiwan setelah mereka menyelesaikan D3 atau 3 tahun studi di Indonesia dan melanjutkan 2 tahun kuliah di Taiwan serta 1 tahun internship di Indonesia, di industri Taiwan. Program CAI ini sebenarnya sudah dilakukan selama 2 batch, namun Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi mengirimkan 7 orang mahasiswa program studi teknik mesin ke Tsinghua University Taiwan pada batch yang kedua. CAI 2 plus I, or we call it Industry Academy Collaboration, is one of the programs for Indonesian students to study in Taiwan. Students can continue their studies in Taiwan after completing their 3 years diploma or 3 years of study, and continue 2 years of study in Taiwan and 1 year internship in Taiwan industry. CAI 2 plus 1 actually already done for two batch. In the second batch, we send 7 students to the Mechanical Engineering Department, Tsinghua University, Taiwan. Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi sudah melakukan beberapa kegiatan internasional sehingga bisa diikuti oleh mahasiswa di seluruh Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi. Yang pertama adalah City Fest Student Exchange. Jadi di kegiatan ini kami mengirimkan 2 mahasiswa dari program studi agribisnis ke Filipina. So Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi already have several international activities. The first international activities is we join City Fest Student Exchange. So in this program, we send 2 students from agribusiness to the Philippines. Kegiatan selanjutnya adalah selain kita mengirimkan 2 mahasiswa ke Filipina, kita juga menerima 2 mahasiswa dari Pangasinan State University. Jadi di dalam kegiatan ini, kedua mahasiswa ini mengikuti program internship selama 1 bulan. Besides, we send 2 students to Philippines, we also receive 2 students from Pangasinan State University, Philippines, to have their internship in Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi. So in Indonesia, they will spend 30 days or 1 month to have a student exchange in Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi. CityFest ini kita juga mengirimkan 2 mahasiswa dari bisnis manajemen bisnis pariwisata ke Malaysia. Jadi mahasiswa-mahasiswa Poliwangi juga yang ingin juga bisa mengikuti kegiatan ini, karena kegiatan ini dilaksanakan secara rutin setiap tahunnya. So beside the several activities, we also send 2 students from Tourism Business Management to Malaysia. They also have 1 month for internship. Selain mengirimkan 2 mahasiswa, kita juga menerima 3 mahasiswa dari PTSS Malaysia. Mereka di sini juga melakukan kegiatan internship selama 1 bulan. Besides sending 2 students to Malaysia, we also receive 3 students from PTSS Malaysia. So they also have 1 month internship in Indonesia. Kegiatan selanjutnya adalah E2Festa South Korea. Jadi Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi telah mengirimkan beberapa delegasi ke Korea Selatan untuk mempromosikan produk inovatif yang telah dimiliki oleh Poliwangi dan juga untuk bersaing dengan universitas-universitas lain di negara lain. So besides that, we also join E2Festa South Korea. E2Festa is Engineering Education Festa in South Korea. So we make innovative product to share and promote that product to South Korea. We also compete with other university from other country. Kegiatan selanjutnya yang telah kita lakukan adalah Creativity Station. Jadi Creativity Station ini adalah kita kebetulan kemarin menjadi hostnya. Jadi kita menerima beberapa mahasiswa dari Korea Selatan serta beberapa mahasiswa dari universitas lain. Besides that, we also become host for Creativity Station. So in here, we receive many students from South Korea and other students from university in Indonesia. So they spend for about 2 weeks in this activity. Kegiatan terakhir yang baru selesai kita kerjakan adalah Summer Online with Asia University Taiwan. Dikarenakan pandemi COVID-19, jadi kita tidak bisa mengirimkan mahasiswa atau menerima mahasiswa. Sehingga beberapa bentuk yang bisa kita lakukan adalah tetap melakukan kegiatan summer, tetapi secara online. Jadi kebetulan ada 7 mahasiswa yang telah mengikuti kegiatan ini, dan kami harap mahasiswa-mahasiswa lain juga tertarik untuk mengikuti kegiatan-kegiatan sejenis. So, because of the pandemic of COVID-19, we cannot exchange or receive students from other university. So, the last activity that we create is join summer online with ASEA University Taiwan. So, we send 7 students to join this summer online. Terima kasih banyak atas perhatiannya. Kami harap dengan kegiatan webinar ini dapat memberikan motivasi kepada seluruh peserta, baik peserta di dalam Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi maupun di luar Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, untuk dapat melanjutkan studi ke luar negeri, khususnya ke Taiwan. Thank you so much for your attention. We hope with this webinar can be motivate all of the participants to continue their study abroad, especially in Taiwan. Terima kasih banyak. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saya kembalikan lagi kepada MC.
Baik, terima kasih Bu Riza atas sambutannya. Untuk acara selanjutnya yaitu sambutan sekaligus pembukaan oleh Direktur Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, Bapak Sony Iswadi, Dr. Engineering. For the next agenda is opening speech by the Director of Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi. Kepada Bapak Sony Iswadi, Dr. Engineering, disilakan.
Terima kasih. Thank you. Before we proceed for the speech, I would like to inform that based on the our law number 24 years 2009, it mentioned that in every occasion in Indonesia, even this one is an international participant, we have to use Indonesian language. So I'm sorry that I have to obey our law, and I will speak in Bahasa Indonesia. But maybe our colleague, Mr. Our colleague will translate in Mandarin. Mr. Jadid Jonathan, please. Okay. Baik, yang terhormat Profesor Jailin, Director of Foreign Affairs Section, Cheng Shui University.
Profesor Jailin, Xianxiang, Jiao Shou.
Okay, Profesor Howard Chang. Profesor Chuan Chang dari Cheng Shui University.
Zhao Xian, Zhao Shou, dari Taiwan University.
Profesor Louis Li dari Cheng Shui University.
Li Zhao Shou, juga dari Taiwan University.
Bapak So Teguh Siddhartha, International Affairs Cheng Shui University.
Saya So Siddhartha Xianxiang, dari Taiwan University.
Pembicara kehormatan kita, Bapak Hadi Purwanto.
Hadi Lausi.
Para wakil direktur Poliwangi, Bapak Dedi, Bapak Fuad, dan Bapak Sofi.
Ayo, tiga orang
para ketua jurusan, para dosen, dan yang terutama yang saya cintai, para alumni Poliwangi yang sekarang menjadi mahasiswa di Cheng Shui University.
Ayo, tiga orang fusiaojang, ayo. 几位校友
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
大家平安，祝福大家。
Oh, bisa diterjemahkan ya. Oke, oke. Pertama-tama saya ucapkan terima kasih kepada para profesor dari Cheng Shui University dan Bapak Hari Purwanto yang bersedia hadir dalam acara yang sangat penting ini.
谢谢台湾的教授，还有我们印尼的这边一些老师们教授们，谢谢你们的到来。
Saya berbahagia bahwa Poliwangi bisa mengikuti program 2+i ini yang merupakan rintisan tokohnya yang di sini hadir yaitu Bapak Hari Purwanto dan kerja keras dari para profesor dari Cheng Shui University.
很高兴大家能够来到这个聚会，这个能这个讲座，感谢大家。
Saya menghargai upaya Cheng Shui University yang menerima mas alumni kita untuk melanjutkan di Cheng Shui University dengan fasilitas yang jauh lebih baik dibandingkan dengan tawaran universitas lain di Taiwan.
我珍惜你们给我们的这次机会，让我们可以在台湾读书。
Bahwa yang jauh lebih penting dari itu adalah persahabatan antara Indonesia dan Taiwan yang sudah lama terjalin agar lebih kuat lagi melalui kerjasama pendidikan yang akan mendekatkan kedua bangsa.
更重要的是我们印度尼西亚和台湾的 朋友的关系, 两国关系,
karena itu saya berharap bahwa program ini akan terus berlangsung dari beberapa jurusan di Poliwangi dan Cheng Shui University dan perguruan tinggi lain di Taiwan.
我们希望能够继续这次合作能够不断继续的往前走。
Sekali lagi terima kasih dan dengan mengucapkan Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Bisa terjemahkan enggak ya? Saya buka dengan resmi webinar ini.
Saya
Okay.
以上帝之名，以上帝尊敬的上帝和亲爱的上帝，我把这个，正式开幕。
Alhamdulillah, kurang lebihnya mohon maaf. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
感谢神。 祝福大家平安.
Saya mohon maaf setelah ini saya langsung meninggalkan acara karena masih ada rapat yang harus saya hadiri. Pak Hari Purwanto, terima kasih dan mohon maaf.
很抱歉了，我离开学校了。
Okay. Baik,
terima kasih Pak Son Kuswadi. Dipersilakan untuk melanjutkan tugas yang masih menunggu. Oke, untuk selanjutnya sambutan dari perwakilan Cheng Shui University. The next agenda is opening speech from Cheng Shui University. For representative of Cheng Shui University, time is yours. Please.
PPT 啊，没有，我是讲那个 speech opening speech， 就 PPT。
我们没有准备 open meeting，对啊，对，请他们先讲。对，先讲。好，先讲，先讲。哎，直接讲，接下来。
Well, I think, Honorable Dr. Harry, would you mind just give the opening remarks instead of us? Because we always consider to cease to believe. I think you have been in our school for several times. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Selamat pagi, salam sejahtera bagi kita semua. A very good morning. Daja sa sang hao. Seluruh pimpinan di Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi, tadi Pak Son sudah keluar, dan Wakil Direktur yang hadir sini, dan juga ini ada struktural, ada Kepala Urusan Internasional, dan juga Ibu Naris ini di kerjasama ya, apa Humas ya?
Saya di Humas, Pak.
Humas. Dan semua dosen dan mahasiswa yang ikut di sini, ada 68 participant in this webinar. Semuanya, especially Profesor Jailin, Profesor Ho Chang, Profesor Loli, dan Teguh, Mas Teguh Sidarto. Good morning. Ni hao. Okay, today we have a very good opportunity to expand our relationship with the Taiwan University, Cheongshu University today, this morning. I think we will have a very fruitful understanding and also fruitful collaboration. And we are very thankful to Polytechnic Banyuwangi for this event can be implemented very well. And we will have many information this morning. I have several information as well. Yesterday, I talked with the Office of Ministry and also with the Tito, Ms. Grace from Tito, Atase of Education. We have an update. So far, the update is the problem is about the coronavirus. The coronavirus, it will be the hindrance of the how we can send our student to Taiwan. Bu Grace from Teto already mentioned about the possibility to send our student, 300 Indonesian Polytechnic students, on this October. That's because the Taiwanese university is already ready to receive our student to Taiwan. As already mentioned by Professor Chen this morning, there will be two Indonesian coming tomorrow, yeah? Yeah, Professor Jailin, I heard. But in Indonesia, it's not only from Jakarta. Yeah, there are several students coming from Banyuwangi, and they have to travel from Banyuwangi to Jakarta, from Medan to Jakarta, and from many islands, city, they have to travel to Jakarta before leaving for Taipei. I think this is still under consideration, whether October we can send our student or not. But now maybe there is some discussion on this, and also some problem on additional money, because now the travel fare is increasing, not only the travel fare, and also maybe we have to apply for insurance, health insurance, international travel health insurance. And number two is we have still don't know yet how our student will arrive in Taiwan, because they have to apply according to Taiwan regulation, they have to stay 14 days for quarantine under, as already mentioned this morning, informal talk. So how this 14 days first arriving in Taiwan will be implemented, and who will to pay for the cost for 14 days, maybe from the students or from the university. But we still discussing now, and I think the information from Chengshu University this morning will be beneficial for us as well, for Jakarta office and also for Tito office in Jakarta. So, but today we will have a session not only about the departures, details, money, and then the health, but we talk about how we can successfully living in Taiwan, studying, and also living very well, because this program is special. It's not like just a fellowship or a scholarship, but this is a learning special, living and studying all together by the student itself. So surviving is becoming the most important thing in this this program. 2+I is living, studying. And I think it's quite a lot for introduction. I think, yeah, sorry about that. But welcome to Banyuwangi. Banyuwangi is the sunrise city of, I hope, Java. From Chengshu University. Sunrise of Java. It's in the west of Bali. I think Professor Jailin, Horchang, Lolin, Teguh, please come to Banyuwangi. Banyuwangi is a very good city, and it's near to Bali. It's very nice, actually, if there is no COVID. Okay, thank you very much for the introductory. I will tell a lot in my session afterwards. I give this time back to Ibu Naris. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih Pak Hari sebagai penggagas kegiatan atau program ini. Untuk selanjutnya kita sudah memasuki acara inti, jadi hadirin sekalian yang berbahagia. Nanti seperti yang sudah disampaikan oleh Pak Hari tadi, selain nanti kita akan mendengarkan dari narasumber tentang diskusi tentang keberlanjutan program ini di masa pandemi, juga nanti mungkin ada sharing session dari alumni Poliwangi yang kemarinnya sudah mendapatkan beasiswa, bagaimana persyaratannya, juga dari pihak Chengshu University, informasi di sana, persyaratan dan lain sebagainya. Jadi untuk selanjutnya, silahkan kita mendengarkan beberapa pemaparan. Nanti ada 4 narasumber di dalam kegiatan ini. Saya akan dibantu oleh Ibu Eka Afrida, SPD MPD, selaku moderator untuk memandu jalannya kegiatan selanjutnya. Baik, kepada Ibu Eka Afrida, disilahkan. Oke, terima kasih kepada Ibu Naris atas waktunya. Perkenalkan, saya Kak Afda Irmawati. Di sini saya akan bertugas sebagai moderator pada acara sharing sessions with Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi alumni over days of 2+I Industry Academy Collaboration Program between Indonesia and Taiwan. Okay, so let me introduce myself. My name is Eka Afri Arwati, and I will be the moderator for today's sharing sessions. And for information, there will be some presentations today, followed by sharing session. And then at the last, there will be Q&A sessions. And without further ado, let us having the first presentation that will be delivered by Mr. Hari Purwanto. Good morning, Mr. Hari.
Good morning, Sao Sang Hao.
Okay, Sao Sang Hao. And ladies and gentlemen, for information, Mr. Hari is a senior lecturer and also a senior advisor for construction services. He got his undergraduate from Bandung Institute of Technology and then his master from University of London and DIC for Imperial College London and doctoral from National Tsinghua University of Technology Taichung. And after this, I will give the time for Mr. Hari Purwanto to give his presentations. So Mr. Hari, time is yours.
Thank you, Ms. Eka. May I presenting my wait second?
Yes, you may, Mr.
Okay, thank you. Wait second. So, a very good morning, everybody. Was already mentioned, and we are very happy. This morning, I will talk a lot about the art of surviving, living, and studying abroad. And this is a message is not only for the student, but also for the colleague, the lecturers in Poliwangi, Banyuwangi. So this is the news lately in 5th August, we have a good news. You see here, I with Professor Jailin, Professor Chen, and Professor Howard here. Where is Teku? I don't know where. So, you know, this is the good news that the glass academic industry Taiwan Indonesia is very popular in Indonesia. And pendaftaran, the registration, and also the jumlah peserta kita harapkan meningkat dua kali untuk tahap yang akan datang ini. Tadi sudah saya sebut, ya, already mentioned. Actually, Tito is already informed that the class can be started, not the class, but the departure will be planned on this October. Yeah, October, 300 students can go to Taiwan. And I think Cheng Su is ready. You see, our friend here is very much ready to receive all of your students, Poliwangi students, to come to Cheng Su, to Kaohsiung. Okay, this is a good news. And now I give some messages to the student. This is not easy living abroad, and I have experienced by myself, and I also receive many complaints from your friend who is studying there in Taiwan or anyone anywhere else. So banyak kesulitan untuk tinggal di luar negeri, ya. Jangan harap bahwa sedang piknik atau sedang berlibur, ya. Jadi tidak bisa menganggap bahwa tinggal di sana itu akan happy-happy saja, ya. Nanti di sana pasti kesulitan lebih banyak, ya. Sebabnya adalah feel like the outsiders gitu, ya. Seolah-olah sendiri, ya. Terus suka membanding-bandingkan. Kalau ada ketemu dengan orang lain yang lebih baik, dianggap rasanya kok jadi orang lain gitu, ya. Jadi biasanya yang pertama dibandingkan adalah nasib, ya. Ada yang dapat beasiswa dari LPDP lebih banyak, ya, atau lebih mudah, duit tinggal datang sendiri kayak gajian gitu, di sana tinggal belajar saja. Tapi justru di situ akan lebih banyak godaan, ya. Justru orang yang surviving itu yang memang kekurangan itu justru yang akan survive, ya. Nanti suka banding-bandingin itu. Wah, enak ya, dia dapat beasiswa dari orang tuanya sendiri, bisa sewa apartemen semua dan sebagainya, ya. Itu penyebabnya adalah kamu sendiri gitu, ya, para student feel like the outsiders. Nomor dua itu bagi yang belum pernah ke luar negeri, kalau Bu Naris itu kan sudah ke Chengdu, sudah kemana-mana gitu ya. Tapi yang belum pernah itu dari Banyuwangi, dari mana itu adik-adik gitu ya. Indonesia terasa sangat jauh gitu. Bahkan ada teman yang dari Makassar, Sulawesi Selatan, Makassar masih terbang lagi, itu kemarin ke Taiwan, itu belum pernah ke Jakarta. Justru sekarang dia udah di Taiwan. Tapi dia belum pernah di Jakarta. Di Jakarta hanya nginep di hotel di Cengkareng. Belum pernah lihat Monas, belum lihat Taman Mini, belum lihat Jalan Tamrin. Nah, itu. Jadi ini, ada perasaan sangat jauh gitu ya. Tapi sementara yang lain perasaan, ah deket kok setiap hari akhirnya bayar pulsa atau tinggal di itu dengan WiFi. Akhirnya setiap hari ngabisin pulsa untuk belajar bahasa Jawa lebih pintar daripada bahasa Mandarin. Karena ternyata kangen terus sama yang di rumah. Jadi terus setiap hari isinya kangen pakai ini, gadget, pakai WhatsApp, pakai lain-lain. Terus yang ketiga itu, karena kalian itu adalah kesana itu bukan seperti turis ya, seperti kayak asik ya, bisa nonton anu artis Korea yang sedang ada di sana. Tapi di sana itu bukan sebagai turis ya. Dan pasti akan menyebabkan ketidaknyamanan ya. Macam-macam nanti, wah susah untuk makan dan sebagainya. Empat adalah berbeda ya, berbeda dengan kehidupan sehari-hari sebelumnya yang ada di Poliwangi, di Banyuwangi ya. Sama sekali berbeda ya, apalagi yang masih new, yang seperti itu yang kemarin di tahap kedua itu yang belum pernah ke Jakarta, tapi sudah ada di Taiwan, itu benar-benar very different cara hidupnya dengan sebelumnya. Kemudian yang kelima ini adalah emotionally itu sangat intense ya, up and down, extreme change, emotion itu kayak roller coaster. Jadi ada juga yang tidak siap, tiba-tiba di sana harus bawa barang sendiri, biasanya manja di rumah, gitu segala macam ya. Akhirnya harus ngangkatin barang karena tidak bisa ngapa-ngapain gitu ya, harusnya bisa ngerjain sesuatu yang karena tidak bisa berbahasa Mandarin, dia disuruh-suruh pakai bahasa Tarsan ya. Jadi makanya kuasailah bahasa Inggris, kemudian bahasa Mandarin, bahasa China. Itu first of the first you have success studying and living abroad ya, kuasai bahasa dan kulturnya. Yang keenam itu siap selalu kecewa, frustasi, bingung. Kenapa tidak semua orang seperti yang saya maui gitu ya. Dan tidak merasa seperti dirimu sendiri, diri kita sendiri pada saat masih di Banyuwangi. Jadi selalu ada tiba-tiba ada perasaan tidak secure, tidak aman, wah ada emosi yang besar gitu, dan harus kita hadapi semua yang ada di dirimu sendiri. Semua yang diketahui itu jauh ya, itu kuncinya adalah sabar. Kemudian yang 10, semua orang yang kamu ketahui itu jauh ya, walaupun ada WhatsApp, tetapi tidak mungkin kita itu ya rangkulan gitu ya, kangen-kangenan gitu. Kuncinya itu adalah cinta. Cinta itu tidak harus berdekatan. Nah, ini apa, sahabat baru itu susah sekali di sana ketemunya. Dikiranya di sana itu orangnya baik-baik gitu ya. Dia orang baik, ternyata enggak gitu ya. Kan tiba-tiba dia punya kepentingannya sendiri segala macam. Oleh karena itu kuncinya adalah keyakinan ya. ketika menghadapi banyak persoalan, ketidakkemungkinan, kemudian ada yang sangat susah, itu bukan putus asa. Ya, jadi ini mengapa di page pertama saya sampaikan the hard things about living abroad. You are not going there as a tourist. Enjoy, ya. Itu dia. Di sana lebih berat dua kali. Satu, belajar. Kedua, juga harus membagi waktu untuk bekerja. Tanpa bekerja dan belajar, maka program ini kalian tidak bisa manfaatkan. Program ini justru sangat elit menurut saya, ya, karena belajar hidup yang lebih berat. Nah, ini dia promise-nya, ya, janjinya. Kalau sukses, maka mempunyai CV yang nilainya lebih, ya. Jadi nanti ditulis pernah bekerja di industri kosong ini sebagai apa ini pernah sebagai supervisor sebenarnya. Dan itu akan dihargain lebih nanti sekiranya akan bekerja atau meneruskan studi. Bekerjanya tidak hanya pulang ke Indonesia, tapi juga bisa ke negara-negara lain karena sudah mempunyai menguasai foreign language, ya, dan kultur industri. Ini yang penting nih, kultur industri. Jadi cara bekerja, disiplin, on time segala macam itu dikuasai. Adik-adik mahasiswa yang di Banyuwangi itu kan PT Inka belum selesai, ya, industrinya. Ya, kalau yang di Madiun sudah selesai. Walaupun itu ada di Madiun, PT Inka itu mau menerima orang murid atau mahasiswa yang internship di sana itu dengan kultur yang disiplin. Bahkan direktur mengatakan lebih baik politeknik itu di sana itu seperti pendidikan militer. Jadi disiplinnya tangguh. Tidak ngobrol gitu. Kulturnya bukan kultur demo, bukan kultur diskusi ngalor ngidul ngabisin waktu, ngabisin segalanya. Nah, itu PT Inka sendiri ngomongin loh. Pendidikan yang dibutuhkan adalah yang semi militer untuk bisa bekerja di industri-industri kereta api tadi, ya. Nomor 3, kalian akan mendapatkan jaringan dunia, ya. Jaringan dunia, bekerja di internship di Kaohsiung, nanti akan ketemu. Masuk ke Vietnam, Shanghai, masuk ke Singapura, bahkan ke Batam. Syukur-syukur nanti juga masuk Banyuwangi. Bisa pulang lagi. Dan syukur-syukur bagi yang pintar meneruskan S2, pulang Banyuwangi jadi dosen. Ya, nanti yang sudah jadi dosen, bekerja juga di industri. Jadi tahu persis, betul-betul, the gap between the industry and also from the academy. Oleh karena itu, nanti akan pulang-pulang mempunyai karakter tangguh, mandiri, dan independen. Dan yang kelima, tadi saya sampaikan, akses ke internasional, baik pekerjaan maupun uang, dan bisa ke membangun startup yang international network. Punya akses to scholarship, fellowship, research fund, bisa ke part-time, full-time internship, bahkan ke apprenticeship. Apa bedanya internship dan apprenticeship? Internship itu adalah magang, kata di Mas Menteri Nadiem itu kan sekarang di Politeknik boleh magang internship 1 semester sampai 2 semester. 1 semester will be valued for berapa? 24 kredit ya? Lupa ya. 20 kredit atau 24 kredit. Then you may get the time 2 semester internship in the industry. Kalau industri itu cocok dan akan menjadi calon pegawai, itu kan setelah melihat 1 semester, katakanlah kalau anak Politeknik Negeri Jakarta yang bagian jurusan teknik sipil internship itu 1 semester, itu dibayar. Ya. Dibayarnya murah sekali kalau compare to Taiwan. Ya. Bayarnya sekitar berapa ya? 2,5 juta, kalau nggak salah. Kemudian, di semester yang kedua dia meneruskan internship-nya, sekolahnya juga dapat SKS-nya, tapi dia sudah direkrut sebagai pegawai Waskita Karya katakanlah ya. Jadi semester yang pertama internship-nya itu di Waskita Karya, semester kedua Waskita Karya udah tahu nih, wah ini anak bagus itu, bisa meneruskan karir di Waskita. Maka dia dikasih duit lagi. Sebagai calon pegawai, kasih duit lagi dua kali lipat gitu. Dua kali lipat, namanya bukan internship lagi, tapi apprenticeship. Nah, yang ketujuh adalah nanti mempunyai karir yang di skala internasional ya, karena memang sudah terekspos kepada kompetensi internasional. Mereka yang sangat pandai dan suka kepada ilmu itu bisa akses lanjut S2 atau S3, tentu dengan akses informasi fellowship yang ada di sana. Ini dua hal yang penting ya, yang harus diingat terus untuk adik-adik semua di sini. Nah, sekarang saya mau cerita untuk yang 2+I. Tapi saya mengambil contoh yang dari universitas lain. Kalau saya akan memberikan contoh from two university dari NCUT ya. National Tsinghua University of Technology, dan satunya lagi Mingxin University of Science Technology. Nanti kalau dari CSU, Tsinghua University, nanti akan diterangkan oleh Profesor Jaylin atau yang lainnya. Saya secara cepat akan menyampaikan hal ini. Apa hal-hal yang harus diperhatikan kalau sebelum belajar ke luar negeri? Yang pertama, baca, ya. Baca, dan mengerti kurikulumnya, the curriculum planning dan pelaksanaannya. Ingat ya. Nah, oleh itu di sini saya akan mengambil example yang ada di National Tsinghua. Ini untuk jurusan Mechanical Engineering, tapi di prodinya Mechanical Engineering jurusannya adalah di Refrigeration, Air Conditioning dan Energy Engineering. Jangan main-main ya. Bukan main kulkas gitu ya, air condition AC. Namanya air conditioning itu sangat high-tech. Ya. Kemudian yang kedua adalah Mingxin, ini di kota Tainan ya, karena kebetulan saya ada civil engineer. Oke, terus ini contohnya ya, baca semuanya, detailnya ya. Harus dibaca ini. Adik-adik nanti kalau memilih, baca semua. Ya, kurikulum plan-nya kayak apa ya. Terus kemudian selama di sana berapa yang harus diperoleh? 72 kredit untuk bisa mendapatkan degree. Jadi minimal nambah 72 kredit. Ada yang wajib 52 dan ada yang elektif. Tapi ini tergantung masing-masing. It depend on the university they offer. Ya. Nah, ini education core. Jadi jangan terima-terima begitu saja. Jadi ada informasi dari KUI ya, dapat informasi dari KUI. Ini. Nah, mahasiswa harus belajar juga membaca sebelum minum obat ya. Ini harus membaca juga. Nah, itu tugasnya KUI ya, Kantor Urusan Internasional mengajari mahasiswanya untuk jangan terima-terima begitu saja, harus baca dan harus banyak bertanya. Sehingga sampai di Taiwan, dia akan tahu persis bahwa di sana itu ternyata tidak seperti yang dia bayangkan, seperti sekolah ada di Banyuwangi, misalkan. Nah, kayak gini. Tahun pertama, ngapain saja? Apa yang diperoleh? Gitu ya. Masih ada matematiknya, masih ada termodinamik. Nah, ini yang compulsory ya. Kemudian praktikernya apa? Misalkan di lab gitu ya. Praktek pendinginan gitu ya, misalkan. Ini tahun kedua ya. Prakteknya ada project study. Ya, project study bisa di industri. Kemudian time ketiga ini di internship. Ini untuk yang di sini ya. Nah, kedua ini yang civil engineering. Saya ngambil contoh di Mingxin University Science Technology. Dilihat semua ini. Kurikulum planning-nya ya. Jadi adik-adik kalau mau daftar jangan terima begitu-begitu saja. Lihat itu detailnya. Ya, ini baru kurikulum ya. Nah, sekarang baca kantor International Office Program, apakah mereka akan menyediakan informasi yang banyak, terus apa ekspektasinya yang mereka akan berikan gitu ya. Penting ini. Lihat dan mengerti apa program-program di kantor internasional mereka. Ini contohnya aja, ada website-nya. Apa kegiatan mereka? Ada link-link apa yang harus dibaca? Ya. Ada juga yang link ke internasional. Ini sifatnya dari Kemendikbud-nya mereka. Kalau ada konsultasi, ada komplain, hotline dari mahasiswa-mahasiswa asing. Kan dulu pernah cerita, ada yang disuruh makan babi lah, segala macam. Komplain saja gitu loh. Disuruh malah kejebak oleh tukang peras dan sebagainya gitu ya. Jadi baca-baca dan mengerti. Kemudian yang ketiga yang penting lagi, baca dan mengerti sistem pembayaran uang sekolahnya, terus scholarship-nya. Pelajari itu. Ya, itu adalah tanggung jawab masing-masing. Nah, nanti dibantu oleh kantor urusan internasional yang ada di Politeknik Banyuwangi atau di dia yang akan menghubungkan ke tempat-tempat yang lain. Ya, ini contohnya ini ya. Kalau engineering college ini saya merahin. Butuhnya sekian. Ya. Terus keterangannya ada free tuition. Oh, ini bebas nih untuk first year. Terus kemudian dapat waive, dapat keringanan 50% untuk semester 3. Semester 4 gimana? Bayar full misalkan. Ya, baca semua itu. Ada full tuition, internship tuition. Ya, ini dibaca semua. Kalau dapat apa ini bekerja itu allowance 150 National Taiwan Dollars per hours ya. Tidak semuanya enak-enak, nanti dengerinnya. Tapi semua adalah sesuai dengan ini adalah kita yang harus berubah. Kita harus mengupgrade sendiri. Kalau enggak bisa komunikasi, ya dikasih pekerjaan yang angkat junjung saja atau yang enggak perlu pakai bahasa komunikasi ya. Bahasanya bisa bahasa Tarsan, ya disuruh pekerjaan-pekerjaan Tarsan. Kalau bisa baca dan komunikasi mengenai kontrol sistem, maka diberikan di kontrol sistem. Itulah. Keempat, di sini nggak biasa tahu insurance, tahunya BPJS. Saya saja kadang-kadang belajar BPJS. Ya, insurance, apa yang harus ada insurance? Cari informasinya. Ya. Semua internship insurance ada. Insurance untuk part-time, untuk student insurance. Kalau di sana sakit, misalkan ya, kena COVID di Indonesia, terus tesnya negatif, sampai di sana 14 hari di karantina. Terus kemudian ternyata sakit. Ya belum tentu sakit COVID juga, ya sakit-sakit yang lain juga. Siapa yang akan bayari? Itu juga harus jadi perhatian. Ya. Kemudian ini yang kelima, ini di Indonesia itu tidak ada, tapi itu biasanya di kantor gua ya. Ada mentor atau program-program pengawalan. Ya. Biasanya suka ada. Pekerjaannya adalah kalau ada yang bingung mau kemana, terus gimana misalkan. Ada yang memberikan spirit ya. Pengawalan. Kemudian bacalah ini mengenai part-time job. Itu ngaturnya gimana? Izinnya gimana? Ya, itu ya. Ternyata harus ada izin toh, work permit. Tidak sembarangan. Tidak seperti di sini. Di sana kalau kerja tanpa permit ya masuk di gelandang, masuk ke kantor polisi. ya, ini ada polusi-polusinya apa peraturan-peraturannya, part-time regulation. Ya, ini semua ada part-time regulation, not strict 2 hours a week per semester, ya. Tidak boleh lebih dari 40 jam per week, baik itu part-time maupun internship. Ketujuh, ini paling penting juga nih, read, understand, mana-mana kursus yang free untuk bahasa Mandarin. Dan saya mewajibkan Mandarin harus kuat. Ngapain sekolah jauh-jauh ke sana nggak menguasai bahasanya? Di sana nanti malah ketemu sama orang Indonesia, malah lebih pintar bahasa Jawanya. Karena setiap hari ngomong bahasa Jawa, karena teman kiri kanannya. Orang dari Aceh, pintar bahasa Jawa di sana daripada di Indonesia. Ya, ini berapa nih cari free Mandarin course? Ini programnya, ya, kurikulum plan-nya. Kemudian tesnya. Diharapkan ini teman-teman yang sudah ke sana sudah ada yang B1 loh. Ya. Memang harus bayar nih, ya, dihitung juga. Ada yang sudah B1. Kemudian harus mempunyai kepandaian untuk mengelola uang, ya. Kalian jangan pergi untuk beli sepatu baru, nonton konser, nanti konser Korea yang ada di Taipei, naik kereta api ke sana, bolak-balik, habis itu uang. Oke, ini salah satu contoh mengelola uang, ya. Karena kalian tidak hanya free terus, karena ada yang bayar free setahun, ada yang bayar 50%, ada yang bayar full, kemudian untuk ongkos hidup, ongkos lain-lain, ya. Nah, ini apa license yang nanti kayak ini apa LSP gitu, ya, di sini kompetensi, ya. Jadi sertifikat profesi. Kalau di jasa konstruksi kan di sini dibayari. Ini juga harus diketahui. Ini contoh-contohnya. Kemudian yang kesembilan adalah mengenai internship di industri, ya. Jadi student akan lebih mengenal industri di sana. Kemudian menjadi mengetahui disiplin untuk bekerja, seperti disiplin bekerja di industri PT Inka, ya. Mereka ingin seperti militer. Kemudian mempunyai keahlian yang hands-on. Jadi nanti akan terampil sekali. Bagi industri, ini misalnya PT Inka, ya, ini bagus nih, karena dia akan mengerjakan talent, ya. Kemudian mengurangi biaya training dan waktu. Dan dia akan mempromosikan industri akademia corporation. Ini kalau di zaman sekarang namanya apa, nikah massal dengan industri katanya. Oke, ini adalah peraturan mengenai off-campus internship allowance per jam $150 Taiwan atau $5 Amerika. Paling tidak sebulan itu bisa mendapatkan $23,100 Taiwan dolar atau $770 US. Bayangkan, ya, di waskita Anda dapat berapa itu sebulan? 2 juta atau 2 juta apa 3 juta, ya, in between. Kehidupan di sana di Taipei sama dengan di Jakarta. Ke Kaohsiung lebih murah lagi. Nah, ini jadi ada industri internship planning. Terus prosedurnya, ya, ini ada ngapain sih internship-nya? Kalau ini yang bagian pendingin teknik, ya, ada chiller, ada performance, ada design and manufacture. Oke, itu aja message saya, ya. Ada berapa tadi? 9 message. Saya akan sampaikan pictures yang bisa membuat happy, ya. Ini dia di dalam kelasnya. Ini ada di Taichung National Tsinghua University Technology. Ini tempat musolanya. Ini saya pernah ke sana. Ada nggak, ya, teman-teman Banyuwangi? Cukup banyak juga Indonesian student, ya. Ini asramanya. Bagi mereka yang biasa datang dari keluarga yang berkecukupan untuk hidup di dalam kamar lebih dari 2 orang, 1 orang itu mereka akan susah sekali, ya. Jadi kalau orang dari keluarga perjuangan itu biasa itu, tapi kalau mereka yang dari family yang sudah established ini akan menghadapi kendala ya, pasti tidak bisa hidup sendiri. Kalau mau bayar sendiri berdua ya harus bayar sendiri gitu. Itu you have to manage your own money to get the comfortability. Ini ya mereka seperti di Jakarta lah, sama ini ada busway gitu ya. Ini yang dari Mingxin gitu. Cerita aja ini ada apa? Ada musola juga. Semua mereka welcome ya, musola, halal food dan sebagainya. Ya bahkan mereka juga ada cultural seperti kita kalau ngantar ke Ancol, ke Taman Mini sama saja. Ada bulan puasa gitu ya. Ini di kelas ya, ini yang sivil ini kalau saya di Taichung mungkin. Nah ini praktek-praktek di sivil olahraga. Nah, hati-hati olahraga, jangan sembarangan, jangan sampai jatuh. Kalau jatuh, kalau belum punya asuransi kalian bayar banyak. Apalagi nanti ketemu sama teman-teman bermain basket yang orangnya tinggi besar, tabrakan kalian patah. Ini terjadi dengan student dari Medan, dia belum punya asuransi, tangannya patah. Sehingga dia harus masuk rumah sakit, asuransinya belum punya, bayarnya mahal, akhirnya dibantu teman-temannya urunan. Nah ini salah satu contoh part-time job, ya, summer vacation. Ya mereka sesuai dengan bidangnya ya. Ini ada di BIM, Building Information Metal Company, ada di Survey Construction. Ini saya berkunjung di sebuah konsultan yang cukup terkenal. Ini adik-adik ini ada 6 sekarang yang bekerja di sana ini. Ini sangat cocok untuk Indonesia. Indonesia baru mulai BIM, mereka sudah praktek. Ini bahkan si Ika ini dari PNJ Jakarta itu mengajak perusahaannya untuk mengembangkan sayapnya ke Jakarta ini. Top One International Consultant. Ini yang ada di perusahaan mapping dan survei. Ini namanya Americo dari Polsri. Satunya lagi siapa ya? Yang dari Kupang. Yang dari Polsri tadinya nggak betah aja, dia mau pulang gitu. Dia belum, tapi sekarang sudah happy dia. Dia sesuai dengan ininya. Tapi sebelumnya dia juga tidak happy. Ya teknologi ini misalkan di Waskita Karya ada, cuman memang mereka lebih pekerjaannya ada di Vietnam, ada di Arab, ada di Afrika, bahkan di Timor Leste. Ini juga akan mengembangkan kerjasama dengan perusahaan-perusahaan di Indonesia, surveying and mapping. Nah ini yang kedua, biasanya kita memberikan briefing. Briefingnya sama seperti apa yang saya omongin ini segini. Saya omongin mereka masih happy-happy saja karena besok sudah mau terbang ke Taipei, mereka dengarkan senang-senang aja karena pikirannya udah nanti di sana ngapain-ngapain aja gitu ya. Tapi saya ngomong kalian bukan turis. Nah ini situasi di sana, ini ada di Jinyi, ini di Kunshan ya, di Tainan. Saya menyempatkan melihat mereka belajar. Ya ini di Kunshan, ini mechanical engineering kalau enggak. Nah ini ya, ini yang sangat fenomenal, sangat surprising. Tsinghua University, jadi please welcome to Kaohsiung. You will be greeted by our excellency Professor Jailin, Professor Howard Chang, Professor Lu Chi, sama Mas Teguh, Professor Chen. Welcome to Tsinghua. This one, awardee, ini teman-teman Indonesia dapat penghargaan. Ya, anak-anak Indonesia itu pintar-pintar ternyata di sana. Kompetisi dapat uang ini anak dari UNS, dia dapat uang berapa ya, mana ada duitnya, lumayan deh di amplop angpo merah ini ada duit, saya nggak ditraktir, luar biasa, dia pemenang ketiga waktu itu. Nah ini industri partner di Cheng Shu University ya, ini sipil ini pabrik construction apa folding isinya, satu ini adalah untuk buildings, yang satu kapal, ini kapal cepat ya, ini PT PAL itu Pak Tau. Kalau di Banyuwangi itu Lundin, yang pernah ke Lundin, cuma Lundin kan kecil, kalau ini gede sekali. Ini sebelah kanan adalah sedang membangun basement. Nah, ini adalah saya minta untuk praktek bahasa Mandarin. Ini teman-teman dari Padang. Saya waktu itu bilang kalau nggak bisa Mandarin, ya kalian ngapain di sini? Cuma bisa mengecek. Ya. Mengecek itu berbicara Padang. Nah, ini ada di Lenghua. Ini di Singwu. Ini anak-anak belajar. Dia bagian hospitality. Ah, ini dia rencananya. Kalau tidak ada COVID, ada 12, ada 300 yang disiapkan. Sekarang ya adik-adik, kalian tidak hanya bersaing untuk mahasiswa Politeknik Negeri, tapi sekarang dibuka untuk yang swasta juga, dan dibuka juga yang dari student vokasi yang ada di universitas. Jadi siap-siaplah untuk bersaing. Bahasa Inggris diperkuat, sekarang mulai bahas. Terus fisik juga karena ini tidak boleh sakit ya, karena di sana nanti akan tidak boleh, ya ini karena kalian ke sana itu kan harus siap fisik dan mental. I think this is my presentation. Thank you very much. Sisi. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you Mr. Hari for the wonderful presentations. Ya, terima kasih banyak Bapak Hari atas informasi yang diberikan kepada kita mengikuti program tersebut dengan baik. Oke, selanjutnya I will give the time for Mr. Jalin. Halo, Mr. Jalin.
Profesor.
Morning.
Good morning, Mr. Jalin. Okay, so Mr. Jalin is the Director of Foreign Affairs Sections, Office of International Affairs Assistant Professor, Department of Industrial Engineering and Management, Changshu University, Taiwan. As the informations, he graduated from Department of Library Science, Fujian Catholic University in 1992, and then his Master of Computer Science in University of Birmingham in 1998. So, Mr. Jalin, are you ready to give the presentations?
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Jalin. Time is yours.
I will share my screen. Webinar chair and Dr. Hari and honorable everyone. Good morning. First,
good morning.
Thank you for the invitation to the webinar. And we are here, is team from Changshu University. We are greatly honored to give the speech at the webinar share station today here. And this is our Chen Professor Chen Changshu and Professor Louis Lee and Kaku here. All of us is from Changshu University. Changshu University, the location is in the south of Taiwan. The city of CSU is called Kaohsiung. Today we are here to talking about what is 2+I. 2+I Industrial Media Cooperation Program for Indonesia. And also we were talking about 2+I at Changshu University. There are three programs in two fields, civil engineer and mechanic engineer. This is the first eye view of Zhengzhou University. You can see the main entrance and the admission building of Zhengzhou University. Yunshan Great Hotel and Chang'an and also Chengqing Lake are nearby. About 2+I Industrial Academia Cooperation Program for Indonesia since 2018. This program is a cooperation between the Indonesian government and the Taiwanese government. Students.
I'm sorry, Mr. J. Yes. Would you like to share the PPT to us? The slideshow of the PPT. Yes. Would you like to slideshow the PPT you make to us? Because we only can see in the first part of the PPT. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, sir. You can continue the presentations. Okay.
Yes. Can you see the PPT now?
Yes.
Okay, so for this program, it's a cooperation between the Indonesian government and the Taiwanese government. Students who want to apply for 2+I program must apply to the school where D3 graduated. The Indonesian government provides a list of outstanding students to Taiwan government. Then the student can upload the application materials through the 2+I platform. Finally, the admission list will be announced after the Taiwan school review. Two-project program provides training course to those Indonesian students with Diploma 3 to learn more theoretical and practical knowledge and achieve co-competency on various professional fields, both on-campus courses and off-campus internship. And this is 2+I website. You can get all the information of 2+I from this website. Advantage of 2+I program. This program is particularly suitable for Indonesian D3 students to obtain a bachelor's degree in Taiwan. Students 2+I can get Indonesian government scholarship and also waive 1 year of tuition fees in Taiwan University. All classes are taught in English, except for Chinese language course. So student also can learn Mandarin here. There are professional teachers come from the school and also cooperative companies.
Of course.
And the school will arrange 1 year or 1.5 years industrial internship. And from this table, you can see the two process programs, 2018 and 2019. 2018, there are four programs in four fields. 88 students in total. And then 2019, there are six programs in five fields. 167 students in total. And you can see the numbers of students is double. And next, we are talking about two plus I program in Chengxiu. Actually, there are three programs running in Chengxiu. It's Spring 2019 Mechanical Engineering Program and Fall 2018 Mechanical Engineering Program and Fall 2019 Civil Engineering Program. So next, we are going to invite Professor Li to show the civil engineering program.
Hi everyone, I'm Doi Di. I'm come from Chengxiu University. I'm also the civil engineering program Hongren teacher. This program in my school, tuition free with scholarship for the first year. This is the issue. And we provide New Taiwan and 5,000 per month for the first 5 months for each student. And we have on campus a dormitory free wave for the first 3 semesters. And also the students right now, they have a part-time job and have an internship matching. For more information, you also can take the website for this program and all the 2 plus I program information in this website. It's 2plusi.csu.edu.tw. Following is a picture for this program. This is the orientation for this program. We have an orientation for every program when the student arrive our school. This is a campus tour, and we have a safety training for every student, also include a dormitory safety training. We have a Kaohsiung city tour in first week, include introduce to every student about the life environment and also the transportation environment. This is a curriculum map. This program includes a general education course and the professional course and the internship course. This is this is the Chinese course. The Chinese course includes the culture and the language learning. In this program, we have two students. They spend about 6 months to award the certificate. It's a B2 certificate. This is Angeline English. We have a protest before the semester. Then we have a Angeline topic for each week to teaching the Angeline English for every student. This is a serving and the practice course. In our department, we have a tap the machine for students to practice and learning. For the material course, we have a kind of teaching to teach the student, then student is like this course. In the master course, we have the computer aid for the materials. This is the building information materialing course. They use the computer to design and then in the BIM program. This is the computer aid drawing and the parties. And the student also use the computer to design the construction. This is a computer aid engineering analyze. After the course, we have a 1.5 year for the internship. But right now, when students got a work permit, they also can have a part-time job during the semester. Every semester, during the semester, the student can have a part-time job 20 hours per week. But in the summer and the winter break, they can have a 40-hour part-time job per week. In the last 4 semesters, they have an internship. The internship is 20 hours per week. It's meaning 360 hours per semester. The part-time job and the internship, they can get the 158 per hour. Most part-time job opportunity and the internship is same company in this program. Before the part-time job and the internship, the student must have an interview. from the companies. This is a student, they went to part-time job this semester. Also, this is the part-time job from our cooperation partner. In this program, we have a six company cooperation partner. Later, we will add about five new company as our partner later. The following time, we involve Howard Chen to introduce the program, mechanical engineering program.
So how's it? Can you hear me? Hi everyone.
Yes, I do.
Okay, yes, sounding clear?
Okay, very thank clear. You.
Well, yes. Now it's my turn. Yes, actually I serve as the homeroom teacher for the first batch 2+5 program student here in Taiwan. Yeah, and for this specific program, each class actually have been assigned for two homeroom teacher and I just serve one of these two. And along with that, we have one assistant to help for all kinds of class trivial things, for that kind of things, academic study and applying for working permit and everything. So the student, the incoming student, they don't have to worry about all kinds of trivial things. At this time, the sister or the ladies can help out at this time. Yeah, and yeah, Dr. Harry just mentioned that surely we agree currently we have impact by the COVID-19. But here in Taiwan, I would say it's so far, as far as I know, this is one of the safest place in the whole world. And we only suffer little impact from this kind of pandemic issues. And all kinds of industry resume gradually. And surely, fall semester, I mean, the regular academic semester will start as usual. Yeah, and sure, this program offer one, I mean, this kind of 2+5 program, it lasts for 3 years. And here in our school, this specific program dedicated to mechanical engineering. The student will study 1.5 years at school. I mean, they kind of on-campus study to learn some more theoretical lessons. At the same time, the later half, 1.5 years, the student have to practice that kind of campus internship to learn some more practical experience. Yeah, and surely, let's say the policy from our school, at this time is, you may see it's sort of just like Professor Lee just mentioned that we offered to the civil engineering students. Allow me to address a little bit more about this right here. And surely the students come to our school, or they will get a tuition fee waived scholarship for the first year. That means the student don't have to worry about the tuitions for the first year study in our school. And at the same time, the student will receive a stipend of roughly $5,000 per month. If you have no idea about this kind of money, I will say it's just about 200,000 Indonesian rupees to make it maybe more clear to you. And the next, an on-campus accommodation, I mean, for the first 3 semesters, when the students study on campus, they don't have to worry about the living costs. We offer free dormitory living at this time. And the next, the student currently, they just finished their 1.5 year on-campus study. But currently, as I mentioned, it's the present time is the summer vacation here in Taiwan. So the student actually just like to continue their or maybe I should say, proceed before they proceed to the internship. Now they have a part-time job, and actually the part-time job is offered by the internship company. So it's what happened just right now. But surely before that, the student have already improved Mandarin a lot, because I think no matter study on campus, and you cannot just stay in the class in the classroom for long. And the student, as far as I know, some of the students, they stick to their classmate in the dormitory and only speak Bahasa. And I always encourage them, this is not the right way to improve their Mandarin. The best way to overcome the language barrier to speak it and use it and read it a lot. And I think most of students did a good job, and most of the students have passed at this C level, C1, C2, and even get a B1 degree for the Chinese test. And that's great, that's great. And surely, and I will say, after this kind of internship, we always encourage them to proceed to a master degree or even PhD degree. We offer that kind of degree in our school, and surely the student even can choose to be to study, to apply for the other program offered by the other Chinese universities at the same time. I think if the student would like to be, let's say, a university or college faculties, it would be better they can they can proceed to higher degree study, not just be satisfied about a bachelor degree only. Yeah. And so the next, here I would like to show some picture to you at this time. And this is in our school, as you can see, for each department, all kinds of computer or instrument have been installed in the laboratory. And as you can see, all the students can have his or her own settings. They don't have to share all kinds of equipment with the other student at this time. But this is just the basic equipment, the regular view in our school. And this is from the workshop, from the work. And at this time, for the student who major in mechanical engineering, it might be easy for you to catch up at this time. This is a computer, computer at manufacturing and practice. This is the regular, looks like, at first sight, it looks like the regular CNC machine. I agree, yes. But as you can see right here, and I think last time when Dr. Harry visited our school, I think this is a surprising new machines and the first installed in our school. Yes. And also, as far as I know, most of our sister school in Indonesia, they have that kind of, they so-called three axial CNC machine. They can launch the regular chip in and everything you want to do. But here, this machine, the assistant tried to help the student to operate, show them how to operate this kind of machine. It's the five axial CNC machines, much advanced than the regular 3XL1. And what's even better, here in Taiwan, our school is the top tier of this kind of mechanical engineering field. So we have a machine so-called plus minus. Why we say plus minus? Because the student, you know, for the CNC machine, they simply chip down, chop out certain part of a piece of metal to form the final product you want to have. But at this time, sometimes if you have a notch or do some little damage to the final piece, they may not be able to pass the QC or even, let's say, a turbine fan from the airplane. In most cases, this kind of part will simply discard, but they are expensive. So at this time, the cutting edge, so-called plus minus CNC machine. The machine can use the laser beam, and try to melt down certain metallic powder, alloy powder to weld in with the original piece and try to fix, let's say, the turbine fin, just like that, the blades. So it's here, the prospect students try to study this program. We'll learn how to use this kind of cutting edge machine at this time. Yeah. It'll be too fast. Should I slow down a little bit?
Kenapa dicabuti?
It's okay.
Kenapa lebih main gue? Pasangan lah.
Should I slow down a little bit? Oh, it's okay.
It's okay.
Okay. And the next is again. This is just show you one of the pictures. How the student learn some programmable logic controller application and practice in each laboratory at this time. And here is the reverse engineering and practice. The student can learn about the theory and the practical experience from the reverse engineering, how to take apart a brand new or the whole machine and use this kind of reverse tech, try to rebuild the other kind of model and improve it even better. And surely at this time, I would like to address a little bit more about what Dr. Harry just mentioned. Yes, study abroad, study overseas, try to be financially independent is very important. And the student can learn how to manage your own budget, the money in your purse at this time. And surely the student in our school, how we can help them to make both ends meet. And this picture just show how we try to introduce our student to some of our strategic partner. And surely the student major in mechanical engineering, we don't want them be try to earn some money just like be a paper boy or just like waiter or waitress in the restaurant. No, no, we think the best advantage for the student surely can earn some money and still can learn some more skills is just get a part-time job in the company of the same field. So as you can see in these pictures, we led our student to Hua Yong Company. No, please. Okay. We led them to Hua Yong Company, and surely we introduced this company to the student. And surely this company is dedicated to produce some kind of parts for aviation and space and all kinds of parts, and even the just like the all-terrain vehicle for like kind of things at this time. The student can learn not just that kind of practical experience from the company, they also learn some kind of working ethic, learn more about the working atmosphere here in Taiwan. Because yes, the student later when they finish their program, surely they can proceed to their graduate study here in Taiwan or in the other countries. But if they decided to go back to Indonesia and maybe serve the government in return, and actually here in Taiwan, some of the big companies, they set up their branches in Indonesia. So the student actually now, supposedly they are good in Mandarin, and now they know about the working ethic in Taiwan. Sure, they will be there the top choice of the branch of the company in Indonesia. Yeah. And the next is, again, this is the a branch. I mean, I think this is the Department of Quality Control. Quality Control. And the lady, Ravadale, again, she is one of the students from the first batch. I mean, the spring batch of student who learned about the quality control in Hua Yong Company. And here I will share with you a story. Here the student did a good job in this company. So that's why as the, later I will show you, he is the student we use released by in the news by the Ministry of Education here in Taiwan. And actually before the young ladies can did a good job in the company, actually the ladies broke two prop and it cost, well, I would say, thousands of US dollars at this time. But the strategic company, they say, well, the student, the best part for the student is to say no and make some error. Yeah, the company know this part. So even yes, the student learn something, but during this process, they break something. They say, well, okay, I know, because just because you are newcomer, you are the student, yes, that's okay, but simply try to improve yourself. Okay, yeah, this is this kind of story. So never be afraid of make some mistake. And only, I will say only, you can learn something from the mistake and you surely improve every time. And yes, this is news, as I just mentioned, released by our government, Ministry of Education. I think the time is a couple of months ago. Oh yeah, near the end of last year. Talking about the 2+I program student, how they achieve their self, achieve their goal and matching for their further study here in Taiwan. And here, yeah, here is some kind of pictures show how the student before examination, currently they are proceed to their internship. But this is a picture from last, I think is winter vacation last time. They have their part-time job in the company. Yeah, and according to regulation, at that time, the student can $158 per hour. And it will increase a little bit later this year or next year. And just give you some rough idea, if the student during the winter and summer vacation, they work 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, the student can earn the money is roughly, I mean, a little bit shy than 1 million Indonesian rupees. And I think it's pretty easy for the student to live on their own in Kaohsiung at this time, because the living cost is much lower than, I mean, here in Kaohsiung than in mid-Taiwan or Taipei City in that kind of big downtown regions. And the next is we lead a student to have a look at the future internship company at this time. As you can see, we offer a meeting to meet with all the representatives from our strategic partner to know all kinds of policy or program offered by different kinds of company. Because some of the company, they have better offer. But it depends, because some of the company offer dormitory living, but some of company don't. But and instead, they offer some subsidies to the students, for they can have their own off-campus living, they can rent their own place, and even offer some subsidies for transportation at this time. And we collect all the information from the company and later release to the student. And surely lead the student to have a look at the company in realistic stations. As you can see right here, the student can know about how it looks like in the company, in Huayong or the Zhongxin Shipbuilding Company. So later, only when the student and the company receive enough information, the next we try to match the student with the company. But why we say, why we call it match? Because match is we offer the company about the student information. It including academic performance of the student. They say, okay, the score the student earned from each course, and what about their Mandarin performance? I mean, the language performance. They get C1, C2, or B1, and this is all kinds of things the company will consider whether they accept this student or not. And surely, as I mentioned, we collect all the information. They say what kind of internship positions and what kind of subsidies, how much money they can offer per hour, or the other kind of bonus from the company to the student. And the student can choose, and they set up the priority. They say rank number one, number two, and number three. And during that period of time, we offer an official meeting. The student can offer the CV to each company and apply the internship from the candidate on the candidate list at this time. So currently, still, as I mentioned, still in the summertime. So most of our students, they are having their part-time job currently, and the official internship will start from next month, I mean September 1st, according to the academic calendar. And now most of the students, 2 days ago, I just interviewed with them, have a look and to see if any kind of feedback, positive or negative feedback, we can help to help to improve this kind of internship status. And now they work in Huayong, Rongsheng, Baokui, and Qunli. And as far as I know, we have the other Shixin, the other student. The student serve in the office. It's quite different. He stay in the in the office and helping about CAD, computer assistant design, for the kind of thing. And surely at this time, later I think we have several students who study in the second batch of the 2+I program. And that's just Dr. Harry just mentioned, they survived their first year study here in Taiwan. I think we always believe the word from the student's mouth will be more persuasive than us. So later I think the student in Indonesia, just like from Polytechnic of Banyuwangi, and you can ask some questions from your alumni who currently study in our school. And I think we can, during the Q&A section, we can share with more information about this. Yep, thank you. That's all my talk. Yep, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for Mr. Chang, Mr. Jaylin, and Mr. Liu Li for very fruitful information given to us. And hopefully we can take advantage from those all information given. Now we will move to the setting session for the awardee of 2+I setting program. And here we have Mr. Danang Putra Diansa, and then Mr. Muhammad Abdul Aziz, and also Mr. Muhammad Afandi. Mr. Danang, are you here? Mr. Danang, Mr. Aziz, and Mr. Afandi.
Mana ini? Okay.
Okay. Hello.
Hello.
Okay. After this, I will give the time to three of you. Jadi setelah ini, saya akan persilahkan kepada Mas Danang, Mas Aziz, dan juga Mas Afandi untuk sharing pengalamannya di sana, mungkin untuk sharing kepada teman-teman yang lain. Bagaimana mendapatkan beasiswa tersebut dan kehidupan di sana mungkin seperti apa. Jadi langsung saja saya persilahkan kepada Mr. Danang, Mr. Aziz, dan juga Mr. Afandi. Terima kasih.
Baik. Sebelumnya, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Karena sedikit keterbatasan waktu, mungkin alangkah baiknya saya akan langsung saja. In this morning, we have good opportunity to share our experience here. Atau mungkin kita pakai bahasa Indonesia aja ya.
Oke, dipersilakan untuk menggunakan bahasa Inggris atau bahasa Indonesia mungkin.
Mandarin, boleh, nggak apa-apa.
Untuk teman-teman mungkin.
Pak Hari.
Ya, tahu itu sudah bisa belum? Ini hama.
Tian-tian, Pak.
Tian-tian.
Mungkin dengan bahasa Taiwan.
Tian-tian, sama gitu.
Kamu mungkin langsung aja. Jadi untuk kita ini, kami di sini sudah membaginya dalam 3. Jadi nanti saya sharing tentang pekerjaan.
Sama transit aja.
Nah, yang saat ini masih kita jalani. Ya, Pak.
Nanti saya coba translate ke Mandarin, jadi ngomongnya pelan-pelan aja. Nanti saya coba translate ke Mandarin.
Langsung
ni hao, saya cuba nak ke yang kena fang yi
Terima
kasih. Terima kasih waktunya. Jadi untuk saya ini ada di bagian sharing masalah part-time job. Barangkali teman-teman masih penasaran bagaimana part-time job di Taiwan sembari kuliah.
Nah, continue.
Jadi untuk part-time job di sini saya bisa belajar beberapa hal ya, mungkin dari kedisiplinan orang Taiwan, budaya kedisiplinannya, baik dari waktu kita harus tepat waktu untuk sampai di industri, kemudian tanggung jawab ya juga, mulai dari keaktifan masuk, dan juga kerja kerasnya orang sini bisa kita ambil nilai-nilainya. Mungkin
oke, okay, 我想说那个台湾的人真的很好的，因为你们的那个射箭的，online的射箭的，所以他说很多good things，大家可以知道，因为台湾真的很好。 OK.
Terus ya mungkin juga bisa nanti kita jadikan acuan ya ketika mungkin sudah selesai dari program ini, apakah ingin mau melanjutkan S2 atau mungkin kembali ke Indonesia, bisa kita ya mungkin kerja di sebuah perusahaan atau bangun perusahaan sendiri, mengambil dari pengalaman kedisiplinan, tanggung jawab, dan kerja keras orang Taiwan. Mungkin okay. Itu mungkin.
Take the example from the Taiwan.
Okay. Dan juga ini untuk part-time job di sini, kita per jamnya itu kita dihitung 158 NT atau sekitar kalau sekarang 75.000 lah rupiah per jam. Jadi gajinya kan per jam. Bisa nanti dibuat untuk simpanan bayar kuliah. Kalau begitu.
Ya, continue.
Mungkin itu saja Pak dari saya, kan masih ada teman-teman yang lain gitu. Mungkin dikembalikan ke Pak Sawandi, mungkin mau menyampaikan pengalamannya selama di Taiwan.
Oke, mungkin dari Saudara Ajis atau Avandi yang ingin sharing lebih lanjut tentang pengalamannya di sana.
Oke, baik, akan saya lanjutkan untuk sharing session yang halo. Saya akan melanjutkan apa namanya bagaimana pengalaman saya ada di sini, terus cerita sedikit bagaimana saya sampai di sini. Sebetulnya saya dulu nggak pernah ada keinginan atau tujuan untuk kuliah di luar negeri, cuma ya apa namanya seperti kasih informasi sama teman-teman. Soalnya sebelum saya kesini pun saya juga kerja di salah satu perusahaan BUMN yang ada di Banyuwangi selama 3 bulan. Terus saya coba untuk daftar ke sini dan alhamdulillah keterima. Untuk keseluruhan apa namanya tentang perkuliahan di sini lumayan sih, lumayan oke ya, beda jauh dari apa yang saya apa namanya saya angan-angan kan kayak seperti apa ya ketika nanti saya di sini. Seperti itu.
Oke. Okay. Dan naga Afandi, Afandi so naga cai ini tetase dan Taiwan tetase ini naga cabuto so yang, jadi ta hui kui tetap hantu hantu
很好的
时机。
Dan yang terpenting untuk kawan-kawan yang mau melanjutkan studi di sini, saran saya harus apa namanya persiapkan kemungkinan terburuk, karena apa yang kalian ekspektasikan nanti tidak sesuai realita kalian, ya nggak sesuai realita di sini, ya itu bisa membuat mental kalian seperti itu.
Oke, okay. Enough, Afandi. Afandi.
Ya, cukup sekian dari saya. Yeah.
Oke, okay, and we'll move to Ajis.
Selanjutnya,
good morning, Ajis.
Morning, Bu.
Morning, Bu.
Oke, Ajis, would you like to share your experience there?
Ya, Bu, bisa.
Oke, okay. Silakan Ajis.
Dari situ ya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Selamat pagi. Untuk mungkin saya akan sharing sedikit pengalaman saya untuk mulai dari keberangkatan dan juga kehidupan di sekitar Taiwan sini. Untuk pertama saat keberangkatan mungkin tidak mengalami banyak kendala, namun saat mulai dari awal dari pesawat itu mulai saya yang paling saya ingat itu karena kenapa kaki dulu saya berangkat, kaki saya waktu di Indonesia pernah ke Seleo, nah itu kambuh, jadi waktu perjalanan di bandara itu saya pincang-pincang jalannya, namun ada teman-teman yang selalu membantu saya, sampai itu didorong pakai troli buat naruh barang itu didorong. Nah seterusnya sampai sini ketemu dengan Mr. Chang, dan di situ langsung kita diarahkan untuk perjalanan ke Changshou, ke Citashui. Nah, dari situ sampai kita malam. Di malam hari, saya kira kan itu kan waktu di asrama kan dekat dengan klinik. Saya kira langsung diantar ke klinik. Nah, tapi ternyata itu adalah samping klinik adalah asrama kita. Jadi, kita langsung istirahat. Dan setelah istirahat, baru paginya saya diantar ke klinik untuk berobat. Nah, setelah itu, mungkin awal-awal saya mungkin down dengan kondisi saya yang sehat itu. Tapi dari situ saya mulai berpikir bagaimana teman-teman membantu saya dan juga perjuangan kita ke sini sangat berat. Jadi mulailah itu kekurangan saya. Jadi dari kekurangan itu saya mencoba untuk terus meningkatkan pengetahuan dan hal lain yang dapat saya ambil di sini. Seperti halnya... Gimana Pak Yadit?
Kalau saya translate-nya kalau ada hubungannya dengan kamu ngomong tentang Taiwan seperti apa. Kalau cuma hanya ke teman-teman, saya nggak translate.
Oh iya Pak. Untuk selanjutnya, bagaimana kehidupan di Taiwan mungkin sangatlah berbeda dengan kehidupan di Indonesia, terutama untuk yang beragama Islam. Nah, namun orang-orang di Taiwan sangat memiliki banyak toleransi kepada kita sebagai seorang yang di sini bukan dari masyarakat asli Taiwan dan memiliki perbedaan dalam agama dan hal lain. Yeah. Dari situ,
Aho, Asiso, cai, nengok, cai Taiwan tu soh, nengok. 很困难，因为还是是穆斯林的，是你们的很好的，可以帮忙他会，所以他会那个stay 在台湾这个越来越好。
selanjutnya sampai di situ bagaimana orang-orang di sini menerima kita, terus bagaimana apresiasi dari sekolah yang sangat baik, dan juga untuk mungkin di awal-awal kita masih enak karena dapat beberapa satu semester, kita masih gratis dalam kuliah, terus masih gratis dalam dapat biaya hidup, dapat per bulan itu yang 5.000 dolar Taiwan, kita masih santai dengan hal-hal yang seperti itu. Tapi saat setelah di semester 3 kemarin, semester 2 kita sudah mulai merasakan part-time job, bagaimana rasanya yang dirasakan oleh beberapa BMI atau TKI yang disebutnya. Oke, dan bagaimana kedisiplinan orang sini dalam bekerja, dan juga bagaimana kedisiplinan, selain kedisiplinan juga bagaimana mereka menyambut orang-orang pekerja baru. Mungkin kalau di awal-awal merasakan kita mungkin sulit diterima, tapi setelah kita tahu, kita sedikit tahu bahasa dari mereka, kita ngajak ngobrol, mereka sangat welcome dengan kita. Bagaimana dia mulai bisa bareng-bareng bekerja sama dalam bekerja, juga saat kita juga sering-sering diajak keluar untuk main bareng, dan intinya apa yang kita rasakan atau mungkin kita asumsikan kepada mereka itu nyata beda kalau saat kita sudah mengenal mereka.
Oke, okay. Asis so naga kongjo de sa hao se han kunat. Kese ta so naga yue lai yue hao se jiang de.
Mungkin itu saja yang dapat saya sampaikan untuk pengalaman, dan saya buat pesan buat teman-teman, mungkin kehidupan di Taiwan berbeda sangat dengan di Indonesia, tapi cobalah terlebih dahulu kalau ingin kuliah ke luar negeri, karena setiap negara kan mempunyai kebudayaan dan juga perbedaan bahasa. Kalau kalian tidak mencoba, kalian tidak akan merasakannya. Terima kasih atas waktunya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So thank you very much for Danang, Aziz, and Afandi for the sharing. And from those explanation, we can see that there are many more that can we take from Taiwan itself. Of course, from the knowledge. Besides, we can get know the tolerance, the culture, and also the discipline in time. So I do recommend for all of you who want to apply this, this program, just do it. And after this, we'll move to the Q&A sessions. Jadi di sini setelah ini kita akan membuka sesi tanya jawab. So for all of you who want to ask, please use the chat features on the Zoom meeting. You can write your question there, and after that, our operator will try to take your message. But I think here we have already had some questions. The first maybe from Mr. Yedit Yonatan. He asked us to give him permission to ask to all university members in this forum. Mr. Yedit, would you ask directly?
Okay.
Okay. So I will give the time for Mr. Yedit.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Mr. Yedit.
你好，老师。 你们三个老师的你好。
I get
my master degree. 第一个的问题是在这边是我不是学校一上去台湾我们也是将会来那个博士班的 for doctoral degrees 我们可以那个你们的 email 然后 我们可以那个 talk more about scholarship. 如果那个老师 the polytechnic 的老师想回来去台湾了，这第一个的问题。然后第二个的问题是，我们在这边是老师，对不对？然后你知道我们的学校就去那边那个读书的阿凡迪达那跟阿西斯的，我们不知道那个，咱们阿西斯跟阿范迪这个很好的不好的，我们不知道，你们的像是什么意思？然后问题是，我们可以准备什么 for the next batch？ 所以那个我们的学校那比较好，就在台湾的。 是这样的，我们可以准备什么？所以我们的学校的 better than three of them， 这个那个我们的问题的。好，谢谢老师。I need to translate to Indonesian too. Okay, so pertanyaan pertama. Tadi tentang bagaimana bukan hanya murid atau mahasiswa saja yang pengen pergi ke Taiwan untuk studi lanjut, ya. Tapi di sini ada beberapa dosen yang pengen continue S3 gitu, Pak. Pak Ari mungkin, ya. Jadi untuk pergi ke Taiwan, jadi gimana kita bisa lanjut gitu, Pak? Karena saya pribadi juga berencana sekolah di Taiwan lagi. Tapi tidak ke National Cheng-Kung University lagi, Pak. Karena ya untuk PhD-nya sangat berat sekali, Pak.
Ini aja pahlawan.
Cini. Ya, banyak pahlawan gugur, Pak, di National Cheng-Kung University.
Di Tainan. Jadi, itu.
Ya, di Tainan, sekolah saya dulu, Pak.
Saya kenal sama ibu-ibu, apa rektor ibunya itu galak itu.
Saya enggak berani ke sana lagi, Pak.
Saya kenal banget. Oke. Galak
saya. Siap. Untuk yang pertanyaan kedua, untuk para dosen yang di sini, apa yang harus kami persiapkan sehingga murid-murid yang datang ya, di batch 3 itu lebih baik dari yang sudah ada di sana seperti Asis, Avandi, dan Danang. Saya yakin Avandi, dan Danang, dan Asis sudah baik. Tapi apakah akan lebih baik kalau kita lebih mempersiapkan mahasiswa kita. Itu, Pak Ari. Terima kasih.
Saya ya. Halo. Apa saya jawab nih? Ya. Mas?
Ingin menjawab, or mungkin pihak Taiwan want to add some information about the question given by Mr. Yedid? Okay, please, Pak Hari, monggo dipersilakan.
Mungkin saya bantu aja ya, Mbak. Halo.
Oh ya, yeah. Okay. For Mr. Chang or Mr. Liu Li, maybe would you like to answer Mr. Yedid question?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, along with the 2+I student program students here, I would say here in our school at least, we welcome all the regular foreign student. Yeah, and according to the regulations, all the foreign student who like apply their study here in Taiwan, no matter it's a bachelor degree, master degree, or PhD degree, they have to submit their application material, let's say, the formal academic performance certificates. But I would say the most important, try to show the language certificate. Some of the school offer the classes in English. At that time, probably the student, I mean the applicant, they have to offer the document to prove their language ability in English. And here in Taiwan, most of the university and college is require the student to offer the certificate about Mandarin as we just mentioned, for the 2+ size student, they are learning Mandarin right now, and they have to pass the Mandarin test. And I think in Indonesia, it's easy to access the website of TETO. They offer the Chinese test, I think at least 4 times a year. Okay, and sometimes every 2 months, they offer this kind of Chinese test. And the language certificate, the first for the, the student, or even the school faculty or staff would like to proceed their graduate study here in Taiwan. That's the first requirement. And at this time, yes, as to the questions offered by Mr. Yadi, I just wonder, yeah, he just mentioned he studied in Tainan, National Cheng Kung University. Yeah, it's not far away from Kaohsiung, just 40 kilometers away from Kaohsiung. I think, well, at least you survive here in Taiwan. And yes, National Cheng Kung University, again, is just like our school, is one of the best universities here in Taiwan. And I just wonder what kind of program you would like to major. Is mechanical engineering? If yes, and we will say, yeah, welcome. We offer PhD degree in this field.
Okay. Actually, my major is about naval and ship system. Ship system. Naval and ship system.
Oh, okay. About shipbuilding?
Yeah, yes, shipbuilding.
Then I will say, as far as I know about the shipbuilding, the best choice I will recommend is about the National Taiwan Ocean University in Keelung. It's near the end of northern end of Taiwan. And at this time, again, would be National Taiwan University. They offer good program about shipbuildings. But for their program, they mainly about, well, as far as I know, starting from the skateboard, but if you like to earn some more practical experience, maybe the other kind of joint program, and surely we can help try to get some more information to offer you for your reference at this time. Yeah,
okay.
And actually, as we mentioned, some of our students who major in mechanical engineering at first time, yeah, we have the strategic partner, Zhongxin Shipbuilding Company, as the picture shown by Dr. Harry, they kind of two trunk ferry is common here in Taiwan. And no matter is a public branch, public branch offered sponsored by our government or the private sections, for the shipbuilding is a big industry, at least here in Kaohsiung. Kaohsiung Harbor is one of the biggest harbor here in Taiwan. Yeah. So maybe later I will collect, or I can collect some more information for your reference and talking about future study. Maybe why not think about the mechanical engineering to improve the shipbuilding?
Yeah, yeah. Also mechanical engineering. And because my major is ship mechanical, actually, not shipbuilding. Ship.
Okay.
Yeah, so marine engineering. So I'm studying about machine in ship. So so either shipbuilding or mechanical engineering, I will go like that. So maybe mechanical engineering. If it's most possible, it's mechanical engineering, so I will go mechanical engineering.
Yeah, marine engineering would be great. And just like this program over by our school, we dedicate about precision manufacturing. And just like the company I showed, Huayong, yeah, they are dedicated to produce the parts and components to Boeing, Airbus, and that kind of aviation and aerobic, that kind of jet engines, braking parts, all kinds of things. I think they share the same thing about marine engineering. And say, yeah, we can talk about this. Well, let me see. Yeah, we have good policy to offer the student who would like to apply for a regular PhD degree or master degree. I think later we can show our email information to you, and feel free to send us a message. And instead, in return, I will send out some kind of, I will refer your information to the department chair. And at that time, we can offer better information, detailed information about our school policy to you, talking about the scholarship. And the first thing I can guarantee is free dormitory living during your study.
Yeah, for a PhD degree. Maybe after this session, I will get your email, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. So, Mr. Yedit, are you happy with the answer?
Yeah, absolutely happy.
Okay, thank you very much. Bapak Hari, mungkin mau
menambah? Yeah, I support everyone in the Polytechnic Banyuwangi to pursue the education up to the highest level in Taiwan. So, scholarship, internship is open. When it's open, be ready to go. I think this is the be ready at any time. I think that is the recipe. Good luck, Pak Yedi. You may go to Kaohsiung with my
terima kasih.
My support.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Hari. Actually, there are many of us who want to go back for conducting the study, but because of the pandemic, we stop for a while. And we will move to the next questions. It's from Aditya Wiralatif Sanjaya. He is a lecturer at Politeknik Negeri Banyuwangi. Well, I tried to translate the questions. Di sini beliau bertanya, apakah program ini bisa diikuti oleh mahasiswa D4? So, maybe for Mr. Chang, is that this program applicable for D4 students? Diploma for students, because in Banyuwangi we have some majors such as tourism and then agriculture. They are a D4 students, so not diploma 3. Is it applicable for them?
Okay. Yes, I think this is a G2G, I mean government-to-government program, and we are happy to accept those talented students endorsed by the Polytechnic and the Indonesian government. And surely, by the first time, according to regulation, is we accept the D3 student. However, at this time, if the student who have earned the D4 degree and still endorsed by the Indonesian government, I think it's still acceptable, that's fine.
Okay, so it's possible. Jadi bisa ya Pak Wira. And the next question, so they finish their education first. I mean they have a certificate of graduations, or they can join this program even they are just on the 6th or 7th semester. So they finish first, or they can take the program while they are on the 7th or 6th semester.
So that's you have to be. Excuse me, you mean the students still in their senior year in the college or university before they earn the D4 degree?
Yes. Is it possible for them?
Mm-hmm, yes. Mm-hmm. I think still the major point is still subject to the endorsement from the school. If the school is on the list offered by the Indonesian government, and surely a student if endorsed by the school as well as the government, we can accept that.
Okay.
Yeah, since the students still haven't finished their D4 program, but simply equivalent or better than D3, I think it's acceptable.
Okay, jadi begitu ya Pak Wira, jadi bisa meskipun masih semester 6 atau 7, jadi tidak harus selesai atau mendapat ijazah dulu. Betul seperti itu Bapak Hari? Atau Pak Hari ingin menambahkan?
Ya, prinsipnya begitu, prinsipnya adalah kita tidak mempersulit ya. Jadi dulu ada yang namanya MEME, multi entry multi exit, jadi yang terdaftar sebagai D4, kemudian dia mau lulus D3, no problem,
dapat sertifikat, dapat ijazah. Tapi memang program ini mungkin karena COVID, pergantian menteri jadi belum begitu in place. Jadi ya prinsipnya kita sejak dulu adalah demikian. Jadi bisa pindah, baik pindah politeknik, misalkan pindah ke Batam karena dia orang tuanya pindah atau dia bekerja di Batam untuk meneruskan D4-nya, atau dia pergi ke Taiwan. Itu principle of multi-entry, multi-exit. Sudah ada Kepmen Ristek Dikti, zamannya Pak Profesor Nasir, cuman juklaknya itu belum nyampe-nyampe ke teman-teman di Politeknik, ya, masih ada di Ban PT dan sebagainya. Jadi, as long as the Taiwan University, like Chengshu University, would accept the student of the seventh semester, it's no problem for us actually, and they will get the degree from Chengshu University. Yeah,
okay.
But from Poliwangi, I think it's up to Poliwangi State University what they will give for the student. It's a certificate, it's a diploma, I don't know. Unless they will have more cooperation in double degree. So Poliwangi and Chengshu make an agreement, a double degree. So the student of the sixth semester or seventh semester go to Chengshu, and then they will get degree from Poliwangi and also from Chengshu. So both got two degree from Poliwangi, Polytechnic State Banyuwangi, and also the bachelor degree from Chengshu University. Actually, this is easy and it's simple. There is no any problem at all, but only because of the situation COVID, there is something administration lagged behind. But welcome, because Chengshu is already welcome. We absolutely welcome, very welcome to do this program. Thank you.
Okay, terima kasih banyak Pak Hari untuk tambahan informasinya. Jadi bisa ya untuk yang semester 6 atau 7 jika ingin melanjutkan ke Chengshu, karena untuk pihak Chengshu-nya sudah terbuka, mungkin nanti tergantung pihak Poliwanginya dulu bagaimana, begitu Pak Wirda. Tapi kalau untuk applicable, iya, sangat mungkin sekali. Oke, okay, mungkin ada next questions.
Excuse
okay.
me?
Yes, sir.
May I address a little bit more about that, the formal questions?
Yes, yes, yeah. Of course, you may.
Yes, followed by Dr. Harry's words, yes, at this time, since this is a G2G program, yes, if the student get endorsed by the Indonesian government, surely the student can proceed their study here in Taiwan in Zhengxiu. And at this time, surely if Polytechnic Banyuwangi would like to sign the other kind of agreement with Zhengxiu, and we can form the dual program. And when the student earn the bachelor degree from Zhengxiu and is recognized by the Polytechnic Banyuwangi, surely the student can then the degree from both school at this time. Yeah, but I will say that along with the program, we have to sign the school-to-school contract. I mean, the agreement should be finished before the student enter Taiwan.
Good, very okay. good. I think
okay.
this is the most advancement, this meeting, and also the... the history. Chengshu and Poliwangi will be the first double degree program together starting
okay.
next year.
I mean,
congratulations to both of you.
It's very good news. So student can get double degree both from Poliwangi and also from Chengshu University. Wow, it's very good news. So I haven't received more questions here. Anyone maybe who want to ask?
If there is no question, you may write a question and suggestion to us, and then we will give the answers.
Okay, we'll wait for a second first. Maybe there are more questions arrive.
Maybe okay, the students are the same, yeah? Because
yeah.
this is an Indonesian way.
in Taiwan or anywhere, United States, Africa, Europe, you cannot be shy. Otherwise, you will get lost. So,
okay. Mungkin adik-adik yang mau bertanya, silahkan. Gak apa-apa kok pakai bahasa Indonesia, it's okay. Nanti kita akan bantu translate, kita sampaikan ke pihak Cheng Sui University. Ini kesempatan kalian untuk tanya-tanya apa saja mungkin di sana yang dibutuhkan, seperti apa programnya, karena it's really worthwhile for you, for your future, and it will very benefit, I think. And yes, like, tadi kan ada Pak Yedit yang menggunakan langsung chat langsung, or you can be like Mr. Wira, that write your questions on the chat room di situ, silahkan yang mau bertanya mungkin.
Ini ada yang namanya M. Joni Lumintang, top model.
Siapa? M. Joni Lumintang?
Top model.
Oh, are you there, Joni? Joni ada?
Ada.
Ada. Oke, okay, Joni.
Model dari mana nih model?
Joni ingin menanyakan sesuatu, entah itu kepada Pak Hari atau mungkin kepada pihak Cheng Sui University.
Joni ini model nih dari Minahasa ya. Mana Joni? Hey,
well, when we are waiting for the next questions, yeah, yes, surely I can address a little bit more about how to survive in Taiwan. Okay.
Yeah, you may.
Yes, and at least I will say for Professor Jay and Professor Lee, yeah, we all earn our degree. Professor Lin earned his degree from United Kingdom, and I earned my both Loy and me earn our degree from the United States. Yes, we can understand. Study overseas is really quite a challenge. And how to survive? I think Dr. Harry just could give some kinds of suggestions from his talk just hours ago, yeah. And how to survive here in Taiwan? I would say, yes, study, join this kind of, they say, 2+5 program, study overseas. It's not simply stay on campus. But you really can learn not just from school. You can learn from all the society, the atmosphere. As I always encourage our students, okay, how to survive? You must involve and totally dissolve in this atmosphere. That's your goal. How can you survive? And here in Taiwan, I always told my students, yes, improve your Mandarin. And if possible, learn some Taiwanese local dialect. Okay, not just Mandarin. Mandarin is not, it's good, but if you are to make it better, from good to better, you even can learn some more Taiwanese local dialect.
Okay.
And yes. But sure, that's the first part. The language barrier is the first thing you should overcome. But that's the part most of students just too shy to do it. Most of our students stick to their classmates, stay in a dormitory and speak in Bahasa and watch the news and everything still in Bahasa. I think that's not the best way to improve your language. To study overseas, yes, language is the first thing. If possible, before you the prospect student departure to Taiwan, I will say they can improve their Mandarin starting from right now. I will say here in Taiwan, maybe later I will try to figure out certain kinds of course. Here in Taiwan, we offer the certain course, we call it MOOCs, means Massive Online Open Courses. It's free and it's free to the public. And the student can improve their Mandarin, improve their language at this time and learn some more things before they arrive Taiwan. Yeah, and so improve the language, try to challenge his or himself, his or herself. Try to say, what can I do and what will I do overseas? Surely, and at least here in Taiwan, in Zhengzhou,
all the faculty and staff in the Office of International International Affairs. Maybe let me put it this way. We were in your shoes. We know your feeling and we'll think about in your way. We will do our best to help you. Yeah, I think that's the best way. And I think the first thing is overcome the language barrier before you come to Taiwan is the best way. And if you apply this kind of program, surely I know the student have to offer certain kind of certificate about their formal academic performance from the polytechnic. And since all the courses given in English, if the student have difficulty to improve their Chinese, the Mandarin at first time, improve the English is also important. Is important here in Taiwan. Surely, I won't say the student can communicate with anyone on the street in English without difficulty. No, definitely not. But at least the student can try to express themselves and try to reach someone who can talk to them. But I would say English would be more popular than Bahasa here in Taiwan. So if the student can improve their English, surely it will benefit about the application and sure will benefit their future study. That's for sure. Yeah, that's my suggestions. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chang. Yes, mostly language barrier is the problem of the student when they are going to apply overseas. What is that? Like this, but I think like what you said that it can be learned and they need the basic of English, and it's yes, I do believe it. And Mr. Chang, there will one questions yes. From Mr. Jaka. Okay, is it eligible for D4CIP manufacturing engineering to apply bachelor degree of mechanical engineering? Okay, do I need to replay?
Yeah.
Okay, is it eligible for D4 shape manufacturing engineering to apply a bachelor degree of mechanical engineering?
Okay, yes, I will say I would like to divide these questions into two parts. Okay, the first, just as I mentioned, if the student with D4 degree can get the endorsement from the Indonesian government, surely we are glad to accept that, the student. And the second is about, I'm not sure it's he or she. If the student, it's Mr. So he has already earned the D4 degree in chip manufacturing. I think we offer the program is about mechanical engineering dedicated in precision manufacturing. And surely we will accept the student not just major in the same field. We also accept the student who major in relative field before. Chip manufacturing, I think it should be okay for the first batch students. As far as I know, two students major in chip building before. Yeah, and now they currently study in the mechanical engineering. However, I will say surely, if the former major is more close to mechanical engineering, it would be easier for students to catch up with the course or the class material offered by our school. And if the student major in, let's say, energy industry, ship building, ship manufacturing, and even just like as far as what's that? The light vehicle. I think this is a student from light vehicle or something, car manufacturing, something like that, car industry. I think it should be okay as long as they get endorsement from the polytechnic and the Indonesian government. I think it's not an issue right now. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much for the explanation. So Mr. Jaka, so it's very possible as long as there's endorsement for Poly Wangi and also for the government itself. So it's possible for D4CIP manufacturing engineer to apply this kind of scholarship. And sir, there are some questions again from Rema Rizky. Bagaimana dengan mahasiswa D4 khususnya agribisnis yang ingin mengikuti program pertukaran pelajar di Cheongsu University dan kemungkinan terburuk yang bisa terjadi? Well, sir, is it okay for students for D4 agriculture to do student exchange with Cheongsu University? And what is the worst thing that might happen there?
Well, as far as I know, the student who would like to serve as an exchange student here in Zhengxiu, the first, a school, we have to sign a school-to-school agreement, the first. And then, no matter in which field the students major in currently, but there's first thing I would like to say, the exchange student, as far as I know, according to the detailed information from the MOU signed by the Bobo school, I think, if my memory serves me right, the exchange student had the different kinds of visa status. I mean, the exchange student will hold the different visa from the 2+I program student. The 2+I program student, they will be the regular foreign student here in Taiwan. Along with the on-campus study, surely the student can apply the work permit and have the part-time job to be financial independent, to earn their own money, to support their own living. But it's not the story for the exchange student. The exchange student, the visa status are not allow the exchange student to do any kind of part-time job. So financial status is the first thing the student should consider. And surely if our school have already, later in the near future, we sign a contract, MOU with Polytechnic by 1G, and surely we can accept the exchange student. We all, and actually we do, we have done this for years. We have several sister schools in Indonesia, let's say the Binus and UNS Solo. And before the impact of the COVID-19, we received dozens of exchange students from Indonesia. Okay, I think yes, it's possible, but it will be totally different kind of story from this kind of 2+I program. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much for the explanation. Jadi untuk Rema, visa kita ikut program pertukaran pelajar, tapi nanti visa yang kalian dapatkan beda dengan yang 2+I ini. Jadi perlakuan juga akan beda, karena di situ kalian tidak bisa melakukan part-time job. Jadi seperti itu, kalau dari segi bisa, iya bisa untuk dilakukan. Tapi nanti perlakuannya akan beda, tidak sama dengan yang program 2+I ini. Jadi seperti itu kira-kira. Thank you, Professor. And next questions. Ini dari Arma, Poltek Pangkep. Please tell us more information about agribusiness study program, either D3 or D4 agribusiness. Is there any agribusiness there? Mr. Howard Chan? Is there any agribusiness major in Cheongsu University?
No, the answer is no. We offer no program in this field. And and so far, I will say yes, at first time, according to the request from Indonesia government, yes, agriculture is one of the options for the student to choose. But so far, we receive no information. Yes, I will say here, currently, Zhengzhou University serve as a platform on behalf of the other universities here in Taiwan. Can introduce this 2+I program to all the Indonesian students. But so far, we receive no information about is any kind of program offered by the Taiwanese universities is about the agricultural program. We don't know. We don't know. But surely, be impossible. We will give all the detailed information online, and the student can stay close, visit the website frequently to see if any kind of information have been updated.
Okay, thank you for the explanation, Mr. Jadi belum ada kayaknya di Cheng Shui ya, Dek, ya. Mungkin nanti kalau ada informasi lagi bisa untuk diperbarui informasinya, tapi selama ini masih belum ada klien. Tapi pihak Cheng Shui sudah berusaha untuk, dan mereka juga banyak menerima request tentang agriculture. I think it's already 10 past 50. Do we still have any time? One more questions? Okay. One more questions. Maybe. Okay. I think the same questions. Okay. I think Arma have the same question as before. Please tell us the scope of agribusiness. So sorry, almost the same contact with the previous questions. Maybe any more questions? One more? Or Pak Hari mungkin ingin menambahkan? Ini kelihatannya banyak yang sekali yang berminat tentang agribisnis, Pak Hari.
Iya. Agribisnis kayaknya masuk ya tadi di dalam list untuk diusulkan dari Indonesian side. Pak Padono waktu itu sudah menulis surat. ada kan dia presentasi saya ya, kalau nggak salah di belakang. Coba lihat. Kalau nggak salah ada, terus lihat. Cuma memang belum ada partner di sana, belum ada respon gitu ya.
Oh. Ya.
Kita sudah usulkan ini dia. Ada nggak? Ada ini nomor 9. Lihat, ada ya?
Food and Agriculture Engineering ada. Berarti food ini sudah bisa diakses berarti Pak ya untuk batch 3?
Iya, cuman kan kita harus ada respon dulu dari pihak mana, Taiwan mana, universiti mana yang akan menjadi partners. Oh, untuk Cheng Shui kan tadi nggak ada ya.
Nggak ada, jadi, Cheng Shui tidak ada masih.
Itu ya. Ada fish and fishery juga, itu yang yang kita mintakan itu. Jadi belum tentu yang kita mintakan di sana juga bisa mempersiapkan gitu ya. Jadi itu jadi ini ada 12 nih yang
sudah, ya.
Ada 12 yang udah kita mintakan.
Jadi kan kelas kalian yang dulu dari mesin ya kan bisa ke Taiwan bukan untuk
itu aja. Okay, 12 yang kita inginkan.
Oke, jadi sebenarnya kalau dari pihak Indonesia sendiri sudah mencoba untuk meng-apply kurang lebih 12 major, tapi juga butuh kesanggupan juga dari pihak Taiwan sana untuk apakah akan mengadakan atau tidak, begitu ya, Dek? Ini tadi dari Arma juga, food technology, apakah ada? Fishing technology tadi ada ya? Oh, mohon maaf Ibu Arma, ini Wadir 3. Maaf, saya kira ini mahasiswa, Ibu.
Mana ibunya mana?
Iya, Ibu Arma mungkin.
Nggak kelihatan.
Ya, mungkin Ibu Arma dipersilakan untuk videonya di on. Biar kita tidak silakan, salah berpikir kalau ini mahasiswa.
Mohon maaf, videonya nggak bisa di on sementara.
Iya. Oh, pangkat sini. Ibu dari pangkat sini.
Ya, dari Pangkep, Pak.
Oh, ada Pak itu Darmawan ya?
Ya, Pak Direktur sekarang sedang di Jakarta.
Iya, saya lihat ya. Pak Direktur di Jakarta. Ya, kita punya kenangan bagus di Pangkep, Bu.
Makanannya enak-enak. Iya, alhamdulillah. Silakan datang lagi, Pak.
Wah, nantilah nunggu situasi.
Nunggu situasi lebih aman. Ini ini mohon maaf videonya saya nggak bisa nyalakan Pak karena sedang lagi di rumah. Memang saya lihat Pak beberapa program-program yang di launching Dikti dulu waktu kita masih di Dikti. Program-program pertukaran ini sangat jarang yang melibatkan prodi-prodi pertanian. Saya lihat kebanyakan itu engineering. Termasuk juga yang ke Jepang, program-program serupa yang di mana forum sudah tanda tangan itu, saya lihat kebanyakan engineering, prodi-prodi pertanian, atau mungkin apakah perguruan tinggi di luar negeri tidak begitu tertarik dengan pertanian, barangkali ya prodi pertanian lebih ke prodi engineering ya?
Ada Bu, di sana juga ada, cuman untuk program ini mungkin mereka belum anu ya, belum srek atau belum apa ya, belum anu. Di sana juga sama aja Bu, perguruan tinggi itu ada yang apply, ada yang tidak juga.
Iya gitu. Betul ya. Kami ada dengan Yuntech, Yunlin National
Yunlin.
Itu pun nggak ada pertanian kan, di sana engineering sama bisnis ya.
Ya engineering. Ya, ada Bu, kalau pertanian kalau di National University di Kaohsiung ada juga, bahkan ada perikanan. Ada mungkin dia enggak.
Mungkin belum bergabung dalam ini Pak ya, program 2 plus I ini ya.
Di sana kan 2 plus I kayak BOPTN Bu. Kalau di kita BOPTN, di sana masing-masing boleh meng-apply.
Oh, masing-masing ya.
Jadi nanti kita bikin 2 plus I juga untuk Indonesia kali ya.
Iya Pak. Terima kasih banyak Pak Hari.
Ya, Bapak sama-sama Ibu, Bu Arma.
Ya.
Salam
terima
buat
kasih
Pak
banyak Bapak Arma dari Poltek Panggap.
Ya.
Mohon maaf untuk salah mengira Ibu sebagai mahasiswa.
Tidak apa-apa Bu ya. Biar saya lebih muda lagi Bu. Salam Pak Naris.
Iya, salam Bu Naris.
Iya Bu.
Oke, kita punya satu pertanyaan terakhir dari Bapak Abdul Rahman, beliau dosen Polda Negeri Banyuwangi. Mohon izin bertanya, apakah ada slot teknisi Poliwangi bisa sekolah di Taiwan? Oke, maybe for Mr. Cheng, is it possible for our technicians in Polda Negeri Banyuwangi to study there?
Teknisinya ada tiga.
Nggak tahu, Pak. Oke. Excuse me, Mr. Chang.
Yeah. Well, I would say yeah. The first should based on the memorandum or understanding the MOU signed by both party, and I think we, generally speaking, we accept all the faculty and staff from our sister school at this time. It depends on the terms shown on the MOU. I think I cannot see why not.
Okay, thank you very much for Mr. Chang. So it's very possible, Pak Rahman, bisa tergantung MOU yang kita tanda tangani di sana. Jadi intinya bisa, tapi kita merujuk pada MOU yang sudah ada. Okay, you know? Okay, I think that's all for the question and answer sessions. Dan saya selaku moderator sangat berterima kasih sekali kepada semua narasumber. Setelah ini acara akan saya kembalikan kepada Ibu Naris selaku MC pada acara pagi hari ini. Thank you very much for all participants and juga untuk semua narasumber, Bapak Hari, Profesor Howard, and then Mr. Jaylin and Mr. Luoli. Thank you very much for the time. Okay, saya berikan waktunya ke Ibu Naris.
Thank you, Dr. Harry. Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate your help.
Yes, you too. You too.
Thank you. Hope see you soon.
Thank you.
Baik, terima kasih. Thank you very much. We would like to say very, very thank you to Mr. Hari Purwanto, Mr. Jaylin, Mr. Howard Chang, and juga Mr. Lowly. And yeah, maybe we will be very happy if Mr. Jaylin, Howard Chang, and Lowly come to Banyuwangi when the pandemic of COVID-19 is over. Because you can search before come to Banyuwangi, you can search about Banyuwangi, the sunrise of Java. You can find many kind of beautiful picture there. Please welcome to Banyuwangi if pandemic of COVID-19 is over. Okay, untuk selanjutnya kita akan menuju pada sesi penutupan yang mana sebelumnya kita masukkan pada sesi photo session, gitu ya. Jadi nanti masing-masing peserta mohon untuk membuka video masing-masing, untuk kita lakukan photo session. Jadi photo session akan kita ambil 3 kali take, 3 kali pengambilan. Untuk yang pertama nanti saya aba-aba, kemudian kedua untuk slide yang apa, halaman page yang kedua, kemudian yang ketiga nanti page peserta yang ketiga, gitu. Saya beri waktu untuk Bapak Ibu peserta untuk membuka videonya. Oke, kami tunggu. Untuk yang lainnya, Ibu Dora. Oh ya, saya ucapkan terima kasih Bu Arma dari Pangkep, Wadir 3 Pangkep. Tadi pagi sempat ngobrol dan Bu Arma akhirnya bergabung di sini. Terima kasih Bu.
Ya, sama-sama. Makasih Mbak Naris.
Ya Bu. Baik, okay. We will take first picture. 1, 2, 3. Okay, second picture. 1, 2, 3. Okay, the last one. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, terima kasih semua partisipan. Thank you very much for Mr. Hari Purwanto, Mr. Jaylin, and Mr. Howard Chang, and also Mr. Lowly. Saya selaku pembawa acara atau Master of Ceremony, mohon maaf atas nama panitia apabila ada kesalahan dari penyelenggaraan webinar ini. Terima kasih atas kehadirannya. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Profesor Jaylin.
Terima kasih, Pak Hari. Sampai jumpa lagi.
Salam.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, Mas.
Terima kasih, Pak Nitya.
Aduh.
Thank you, Mas. Thank you.
Okay.